gotta get the script out for our like intro.
Yeah, the intro script.
Oh yeah.
I will say, I played that. I'm pointing at it because that's where we were looking at.
Yeah.
The theme song. I played that in the office the other day. Boy, that last 10 seconds throws you for a loop because
we never hear it. Yeah.
It's like, you know, those cartoon shows or anything that had the song. You listen to it and then you go and find the song. And it's like 5 times longer.
Yeah, it's like that,
but only 10 seconds.
It's funny because there was only 12 seconds in or whatever. Michael's going, it's still going.
It's never stopping.
But did you bring the script?
I didn't today. That's so, why we weren't talking.
I didn't get my science last night.
I didn't mention this last week. I think it was a comment on the podcast from episode 15. But a lot of times the intro's going, right? It fades in and we're sitting here talking. Because if you're unaware how it works, like this is like the broadcast section where broadcast sets everything up and they have like the pre-stream where you see it in the control room and all this stuff and they get everything ready and we show up and sit down. We don't show up at 11:59 with 5 seconds remaining and then the podcast starts. Usually we're here like 10, 15 minutes early, sometimes 7 minutes early. And we just have...
That's all I was expecting.
Yeah.
7.5, you know?
Yeah, all time. All time is possible.
Right.
And, you know, believe it or not, we just have conversations because that's what the podcast is about anyway.
We don't just sit in silence and stare at each other waiting for the clock to go?
Right. So, podcast starts. We're in the middle of a conversation. Then we'll get back to the thing. I saw a comment. I think it was on episode 15.
It's when we were talking about the Avengers.
I'm really getting sick and tired of these like fake intros where they pretend like we're having a conversation. It's just so cringeworthy. That absolutely was the word. Cringe was thrown in there.
Of course it was.
And it's like, you think we have a fake conversation before we have real conversations that last for an hour and a half to 2 hours.
Yeah.
Fuck, he figured it out.
I can't believe he did it.
So I think from this point on, we should just go scriptless.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Is improv?
I can't think of our pants.
Yeah. So for example, I'll just be like, this is episode 17, I guess. I don't know.
I think
I'm your host, Michael, and we're joined by Jeremy.
Yeah, yeah.
I think I'm Jack. Who the hell?
I don't know. Yeah, it's a tough one.
Matt, you cut your hair.
Yeah, I did.
That's right.
And
there's two stages of Matt. Yeah. There's long hair Matt and no hair Matt.
Yeah.
Somehow he's apparently...
It's a middle ground.
Somehow you've gotten in the middle. This episode sponsored by no one, by nothing. No one will have us. No one wants it. It's probably the end of days.
Sponsored by the Rooster Teeth Store.
That's,
how about that?
Oh, what a save, Jeremy.
Yeah, let's do that.
Because did you know that shirts come out on a basis of dailiness, and we will wear them. I'm wearing one right now.
This is it. There's another one.
Pemberton.
Emily probably wanted me to mention there's like a sale.
That.
You know, it's like merch Maybe. March.
Oh, double down. I do words good.
You do do them good. You do shirts.
And the glass as well. The glass.
Buy now. Rooster Teeth Store. Buzzword sale.
Wow. Zoom in. Both of them. Whoa.
Now quick, spin the footage and spin them around and then do a swirl. So go buy shit.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think there's a sale, and then there's more sales next month.
Probably.
And that's probably followed by a super sale.
You can pre-order your takeover. Let's Play shirt.
That's right.
New branding hit this week.
That you can
The
do.
Internet just loved it.
Mm. Absolutely.
No complaints at all.
The thing about it was amazing how quickly they latched onto it. Like, I just love this.
They embrace change. They're like, wow, look at this new logo. We love it.
Change?
And we have no issues with it.
I couldn't believe it.
They never have dollar bills because they love change.
It's funny. We're 5 days in at this point, and now we're seeing the turn where people are like, oh, okay, I get it.
And it's not even like...
It took a week.
You know what? I was wrong. I love it now. It's people are like... Yeah, it just doesn't bother me at all.
Yeah, exactly. All right, yeah, good.
For one to two days, it was looking pretty rocky there. Achievement Hunter might have gone under because...
Yeah, we almost shut down.
Achievement Hunter, Let's Play, all of it. Because we changed the Let's Play logo and we switched up some intros for the video.
Yeah.
So, but 5 days later, guys... We're still here.
Still alive.
We're all still here.
I think we have something like 10 intros right now, and we're getting more
incoming.
There are some really good ones.
Yeah, there's some really funny ones that are coming up.
Based on some of the funny ones, I don't want to spoil, that are coming up, I had an idea from hearing it, from the sound effect. I was on the other side of the room. I'm like, Jeff, I got this one. And he's like, do it. So I'm gonna film one at home.
Yeah. Dude, Gus filmed one.
That's the one I was talking about.
Oh, really?
Yes,
Gus is beautiful.
Yeah, Gus is
my favorite I've seen so far.
Nice.
I did read another comment that was like, I can't, it was in the mega thread of everyone's fucked the logo exchange, that I can't wait for Michael to fucking make fun of us on the podcast and be like, I can't accept change. Oh. And then I replied to the guy, how did you get the script off topic? That's where it went, by the way. That guy took it.
Yeah.
So I really can't even, I can't even go systems. There with it. I don't give a shit. Hold people it. Don't like shit because it's, I mean, not even ever say people don't like because it's different. Maybe you don't like it. That's fine. But yeah. Like, it was a very quick, and I'm not going to say it was like everyone in the fan base, you know, the vocal minority took it very harshly for one day. But even those same people already today are like, well, that's pretty good, actually.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's just
like,
a time thing.
Now that you've seen like kind of more of the intros, kind of the idea we're going for, it's like it's not a specific brand. Everyone's like, oh, we're getting away from Achievement Hunter. It's like, well, Let's Play was never supposed to be Achievement Hunter.
It's true.
You know what? Like the green and the black, that's Achievement Hunter. It's like Let's Play, it's something completely different that a lot of people can be lumped into.
Which also we just announced this week, right? Was that?
I don't think we've announced anything.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure. Yeah.
Okay.
Next week.
You had that. Didn't you have that video come out with you and Jeff?
I don't think it comes out.
No, that was the logo thing. I don't.
Right. Gotcha. Yeah. There's so many videos.
There's a new announcement coming soon.
Lots of announcements happening, and we're all happy about everything. And that was about as vague as you can get.
Right.
Hey, cheers.
But seriously, get a Southeast Pemberton.
See, you know, I want to give Jeremy credit, and it's fine because he wore two shirts, and I'm like, man, he went the extra effort. But in fact, what in reality happened was, I said, do you have the Southeast Pemberton shirt? Because it's coming out, you know, and we should wear it on the podcast. He's like, got it. And then he gave me a ride to work today, and I was like, that is not the Southeast Pemberton shirt. And he was like, thought I had it.
It's funny.
Well, I do have it, because we modeled it.
Yeah, yeah. No, I was going to wear my shirt, and then I got here today, and I was like, because I have mine in the car, because I was like, oh, I'll wear the other hockey one, and you have it on. So I was like, oh, crap.
Perfect.
And so, but I thankfully had my Jeff shirts, which I hadn't worn yet.
One of the collection.
One of the Jeff collection.
So which
shirts.
One are you? Are you in a Northern... Was it Northern, North Havermeyer?
It's Northern, North Havermeyer, and Southeast Pemberton.
Yeah, so you gotta pick which one you are.
So, Jack, Matt, and I, Northern, North
Havermeyer.
We're
in the good one.
The good one.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you're in the other one.
I wouldn't throw the word good around, but there's definitely a difference between the two leagues.
So we can say that, okay, the first episodes are up.
First two. So the way it's gonna work is we filmed an entire league, four teams in two different divisions, and it's a 6-week league with semifinals and then finals.
Yeah.
So,
four teams make it to this, or four teams make it to the semifinals. Finals is a two. So.
Right. So week one, or should I say Tuesdays, is going to be Southeast Pemberton. It'll be both games on week one, which already came out. And then Thursday is Northern North Havermeyers. Two games, that's week one as well. So that already came out. And then next week will be week two, week three, week four, week five, all the way up to week six. Week seven, we'll have the semifinals for Pemberton on Tuesday, the semifinals for Northern North on Tuesday. And then someday on week eight, we will have the finals to the whole
week. Yeah, we're working on a special thing for the finals
now. Which probably won't happen, so stay tuned.
We can tell you, though, we were so excited. Like, I mean, we're like, okay, hockey,
we don't like our Let's Plays. And
they enjoyed it.
We got into them.
We have filmed the entire season.
We filmed.
Oh my god!
We got so into it. We got so excited playing it that we've literally filmed all 6 weeks.
I care about this.
We
so
filmed
much.
6 weeks, which is 12 videos, which is 24 games.
Yeah, we filmed.
So
24
we've filmed 24 games, and four have come out so far.
Yeah.
So all we need to film is the two semifinals and then the final
which
match.
Which we'll probably film the semifinals today.
But we know who's in the semifinals.
Yeah.
Don't tell.
We don't. Know.
Yeah.
They don't.
But anyway,
Wait,
did anybody put it in the script? Because then that one guy on Reddit knows.
Oh crap!
He was in the semifinals.
Damn it. Matt, did you take that part out?
I might have edited it.
So the first match, you two played, that video came out today, right? It came out publicly today, right?
Yeah, today was Michael.
Oh, so is it Tuesday, Thursday for sponsors?
Yeah, Tuesday, Thursday sponsors, and
so
then Wednesday,
Friday for public.
I'll double check here.
It's definitely one of those.
Let me make sure it's on YouTube before we get into it.
I think that came out publicly
today. We can talk about yours.
We can definitely talk about Southeast.
Yeah, I mean, Southeast.
So game one was Jeremy versus Lindsay.
Yeah, it was.
Very first game of the whole season. First thing we filmed.
Neither of us knew any controls. We had never played before.
That was also a topic of conversation for about the first two full weeks, is how to set the controls.
How to play.
Yes.
I'm glad we checked, because our video hasn't come out yet.
Good call. Hey, so that's today.
Don't want to spoil anything.
It hasn't come out public today.
Yeah, it's not on YouTube yet.
It's on the site.
So everything I just said, except Wednesday and Friday for YouTube.
We can still talk about it, though, because this is sponsored.
No, but I mean... go pay for
it. That's true.
It'll be out by the time.
That's true, but sponsors may not have watched it yet, so let's just not spoil it. All right, well, Jeremy's video is like 3 days old.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, Southeast. Okay, Southeast Member 10 came out 43 minutes ago. What? Oh, this needs to be refreshed.
Jack, you're losing your fucking shit.
I'm going crazy. I want to make sure we don't spoil anything.
I know, but
this is something we don't want.
Thank God we don't have sponsors.
But in my game, I can spoil because you should have watched it by now.
You should have.
Scored on myself twice in that game into my own goal.
It's surprisingly easy to score on yourself.
I want to say,
yeah, it is.
I'm not exactly sure. I want to say this is the right game, but you may have scored on yourself twice and moved your goalie completely out of the way once, letting in a third goal, like completely unguarded.
I don't know if Lindsay got that third goal.
I think that was game one.
That sounds correct.
I'm pretty sure. A lot of hockey going on. It's hard to keep track.
Lots of hockey.
That pretty much sums up. Like, this one's one other thing to say that Northern Nor North Havermeyer.
Very simple. Yes. That's why on the shirt it's
not even spelled out.
Yeah. They are definitely the you guys, like, are better at hockey. You're very good with like the fundamentals and the moves.
Yeah.
Like watching it is like watching a hockey game most of the time.
It's funny because like, everyone on the internet says the opposite.
Well,
I understand
that there's no rules turned on and that we actually suck.
It looks like I'm watching hockey. You know when there's seven players inside the goalie net with the goalie and they just keep stabbing him with a stick?
Jabbing at him.
Screaming drop it over and over again.
Imagine like, so watching them is like, you go in, you're like, oh no, who's going to win this? This is going to be like, you're going to see a lot of good moves and spins and all kinds of stuff like that. You watch Southeast Pemberton, you're like, someone's sliding across the ice and the goalie's like on the other side of the ring.
You're not
like,
wrong.
Pemberton is a mess.
You still don't know who's going to win that.
I can say, without spoiling anything, in 6 weeks of games, we called some where I thought it was going to go this way and we were right, but so many of the games are completely what you would not expect.
A lot of surprises.
This person beat this person, and then you're like, oh, they're going to kick the crap out of them. Destroyed.
Oh, yeah.
Like, it's just all over the place.
Jeff walked in one day and you were like, oh, so-and-so beat so-and-so in their game, and he was like, what?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
really?
Here we go.
Yeah.
Oh, so, man, who is this one?
Oh, this is me and Jeff, actually.
Okay, so this is the video that's probably out for sponsors.
Yeah, yeah. So this, this is Jeff and I's first game. I'm playing as the Dallas Stars. He is the Tampa Bay Lightning. And,
I remember this being a good
Sam
game.
Harris, see the goalie.
Look how far out the goalie is.
It just
flies
it away.
Okay.
Now, I'm pretty sure when the rules are turned on, he's safe down there because the other players can't go at him.
Yeah.
That right there, if you're watching the video, the goalie, or if you're not watching, the goalie was on his hands and knees, like doggy style. That's most of every one of our games.
Oh,
the goalie just going, stop!
Yeah. Please,
stop!
Please, no!
And people just kicking the
shit out
of him.
Because the thing is, since there's no rules turned on, the goalie, if he sits on the puck long enough, it'll freeze it.
Yeah,
and then
you blow a whistle and you do a face-off.
Yeah, you do a face-off. But in a normal game, that's fine. In this game, the goalie will sit on it, and there will be two or three players around him going,
literally the only way it's possible with the rules turn off for the whistle to blow and do a face-off is if the goalie gets the puck and he doesn't release it in a few seconds, or if you hit it out of the ice rink.
Which is
happened a lot.
But I will say, it's awesome because if there are penalties on, we all suck. We get stopped every 2 seconds.
Yeah.
And this way, I mean, it's just savage. Or if someone scores a goal, obviously.
Yeah.
But it's
like
just
personal fouls
fucking
too, I think.
Savage nonstop the entire time.
It's
and it's
bad.
Very different play styles. Like, I don't think this is much of a spoiler if you've seen the other Aki Let's Plays. Ryan just fucking tries to kill people.
He's just like, and throws characters at every match. He keeps sitting there. He goes, fight, fight, fight. Closer right behind you.
Ryan got really good at two things in hockey, and it sucks. He got really good at fighting.
And screaming poke.
And poking.
Yeah.
Poke.
You get the puck, Ryan's like poke.
Yeah,
poke.
And it's
just
gone.
It's just like flies away
like skating.
Also,
I don't know if, I think he did this in episode in the first week of Pemberton, because also the second game was Ryan versus Gavin, and that was a fucking corker. And Ryan screaming nonsense. Over and
nonsense,
over
poke, and
no,
fight.
That's out already. I'm
oh,
saying
yeah,
that
no,
game
yeah.
one was you and
oh,
Lindsay.
Okay, that
game
was,
two
yeah,
was,
yeah.
was right, Gavin
good,
and Ryan.
Yeah.
That
oh, God, Ryan was
awesome.
So upset at the end of that game.
Yeah, let's just say he was upset.
Yeah,
you should watch it. He just kept screaming nonsense over and over again.
Yeah.
So the
literally
nonsense.
The word nonsense.
Yes,
he wasn't
nonsense.
Talking. He wasn't saying
nonsense.
Like, oh, blah, 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 blah. He was. He literally said the word nonsense.
Yeah. So nonsense, poke, fight shirt.
Yeah, I'd say that at some point.
Yeah.
It could be like that New York shirt where it's like Manhattan and Brooklyn. It would be like nonsense and poke.
Nonsense,
and fight,
poke,
and,
fight.
And hockey, yeah.
Which is how most fights go.
Achievement Hunter.
This episode of Off Topic originally aired March Oh, shit, I got a phone call. March 25th, 2016. If you'd like to watch it live every Friday at noon Central Time, then you should go to roosterteeth.com and sign up to be a sponsor. You can click this link right here. The first month is completely free, and it's under $3 a month after that. Three freaking dollars? You want to see the podcast live? Boom. You want to see theater mode? We're going to watch some movies, and you'll be there. I'll be there, probably. So check it out and enjoy the episode. You jabronis. It's been super fucking fun, and I think a fair way to describe it is the early games are us trying to figure out how to play. We never really learn how to play, but we know how to play against each other at least. So the beginning is kind of like we have no idea what we're doing. It's kind of slow. There's like just us figuring it out. Yeah. As it picks up like week 3 and 4, it's just like pure fucking chaos. Everybody's like screaming and yelling shit. But as we get to week 5 and 6, we've all played the game so much and now we want to play. And these are like the most important games because it determines who gets in the semifinals. And they get super tense and quiet from at least the people playing. Yeah, like, we have fucking five people in every video.
That's the best part.
So it goes up and down all over the place.
It's like the NBA All-Star games, you know, where it's like there's kind of screwing around in the beginning of the game. By the end of it, they're like, oh no, I don't want to lose this game. I don't want to lose. And then they actually start playing. It's like,
awesome
oh my God.
Like,
the best part is that I mean, week 6, which is still just games leading up to the semifinals, it still matters.
Yeah,
like, that's how good people are. Yep. It's still it's not like, you know, to an extent, nobody's, like, just out of it. You know? I mean, like...
Because the way it works in, like, actual league, which, you know, I don't know. I don't know shit about sports, let alone hockey, but... I don't know if we have like much of a representation in the video for it, and I talked to Jeff about it, and we will if it's a problem, but because near the end, the way it works is only 2 people of the 4 go into the semifinals. Mm-hmm. So if you end up tying in wins and losses, right? So, you know, you play 6 games. So if 2 people are 3 and 3, the way it determines who does better is it goes who scored the most goals throughout the entire league.
Well, the first tiebreaker is heads up. So,
it's
overall record and then heads up matches.
Right, so who's won against each other?
And then from there, points scored, and then from there, points
if
allowed.
Those are all tied.
Yeah, yeah.
So if everything's tied, it keeps going down. So, it does matter not just who wins and loses near the end of the weeks, but like some people need to win and win by a margin of a certain amount of points and stuff like that. So, it has been so much fucking fun.
And that's
to play.
Why it's really stupid, because usually it's like, again, Northern Havermeyer, good at hockey. So usually it's like a regular game, you know, with legitimate scores. Pemberton, you'll get like 7-5
there
or something.
Go,
like,
go.
There's a ton of goals. Like, people just don't care.
I won't. I'm not in Pemberton.
North Havermeyer.
Yeah, look at that.
Yeah, who did the photoshops of us that are all messed up?
Steffi.
Somebody in the support room.
Gavin looks red.
Gavin's is the best. Because we all look, I mean, they just take photos and they
if you can find Gavin, put it out there.
Gavin, he actually got a little upset when he saw it. Why does mine look like that? Because he looks so stupid. Like, they distorted his face. They gave him, like, a black.
He's missing a tooth.
He's missing several teeth.
Yeah.
Like, and not only that, but he hates the photo they use. He's like, "Well, what's that photo from?
Yeah.
Where's that from?"
You point out like Lindsay's.
Lindsay's is her fucking professional headshot.
Yeah.
That's her photo, and she's got like a black eye. Mine looks awesome.
Yeah, mine looks like me being all goofy. I don't even know where that's from.
I think I look badass.
Yeah, mine too.
I'm not sure where that is.
Yeah. But Gavin's just got this dopey fucking smile on. So.
We took mine in the support room.
Oh, really?
All right. I don't like any of the pictures you have there. Let's go with another one.
Well, it's like, hey, Matt, and just click. Yeah. All right, good.
It's funny. It's funny because it's a stupid conversation, but with us especially, and stuff like that we use in the office for you know, like our faces in our own videos and stuff like that. Usually we go for like a better quality photo, and there's a billion photos of us online from videos and stuff like that, but usually there's a smaller reserve of like high quality photos, like a store photo or something like that.
Yeah.
So it's funny, it may seem like a weird thing to say, but for us, it's usually like, oh, I know where that photo's from. Like I've mentioned it before, but Griffin, for our wedding, made this chainsaw carved this like immaculate, framed portrait of me and Lindsay, and I'm like dressed as Link and Lindsay's dressed as Zelda, and it's got jewels inside of it and it's fucking incredible. But the second I saw it, I was like, oh, that's a store photo. Like, she took a store photo of us standing together and then just like, you know, Photoshopped or, you know, whatever, like the clothing over it. And I mean, it looks like, you know, she made that from nothing. It looks amazing. But that's the first thing I saw. I was like, oh, I know where that photo is. So it's like, for us to be like, I don't even know where that photo's from.
It's a kind of a thing. That being said, we have so many photos taken of us. I mean, like, that's the thing. Like, I don't take any photos like RTX and stuff for conventions because I know there's going to be like 8,000 photos of me anyway. And it's like, oh, let's go pull down some. I'll put those on my Facebook and it'll be fine. So,
dude, Laser Team worked out great for me.
Oh, yeah.
I got headshots for days.
It was an hour and a half long photo.
Your face is all over New York City. You got billboards everywhere.
It was.
Yeah. So
I actually is kind of completely irrelevant to that, but I just changed my my headshot, my Twitter profile for the Doom thing we're doing.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Because the Day of Doom, which is a Doom live stream tournament of the
four teams
new Doom game sponsored by Bethesda.
I'm jealous. I'm jealous.
Yeah,
and I would like to play that.
We just I think yesterday or the day before put out the
trailer came out yesterday. The trailer, or the announcement came out yesterday.
The announcement for the stream, which is on the 29th on the Rooster Teeth YouTube channel. And
youtube.com/roosterteeth/live.
Yeah, there
or
you
gaming.youtube.com/roosterteeth/live.
Probably
just click a link.
Okay,
but
cool.
Yeah. Sure. but it's sponsored by Bethesda, and there's a shot in there where it's like a crazy trailer, like it's all Doom and shit's exploding and blah blah blah. And Adam Ellis did the voiceover.
Oh,
he
did great!
Fantastic.
That was Ellis.
Yeah, that was Adam
what?
Ellis.
What? I didn't even know that.
Yeah, he was fantastic.
Oh, people are like, oh, you got Mr. Torg to do it. Yeah, it's like, no, that's Adam Ellis.
Oh, and we're fucking playing with four fucking internationally famous athletes.
Antonio Brown, Terry Henry, Rob Gronkowski.
Yeah,
you and Gronk. I'm so excited.
Oh my god!
And then Ocho Cinco, Chad Johnson.
Yeah. So
I love that. Well, Ocho Cinco will.
There's a shot in here, just talking about pulling headshots. There's a shot in here, like, we're all doing crazy shit, and at the end, there's like a panning shot of all of us just looking like badass and shit. And I'm like, boop, new picture. It's just because it's cool, because it's a production and it has all the production value and the lighting's cool and there's hair and makeup and everything. I'm like, well, I'll just use that.
I just had Colby in the inflatable tubes. It's like my favorite thing.
Where the YouTubers have tubes.
Yeah, I read the script for that and I saw Kovic and I was like, boys, so what happened?
Yeah.
you got the short end of the stick here.
Yeah, you upset Daniel Fabello.
They shit on Kovic the
but,
entire time.
You're hosting.
Yeah, yeah. Me and Tyler are hosting. There you are. Sportsball reunited.
Awesome.
Yeah, that's great. But yeah, gaming.youtube.com/Roosterteeth. Okay, I added an extra live in there.
Shirt off.
Tyler and I are going to be hosting it. We're very excited, and you guys are going to be playing it. It's going to be four teams, and we're going to do a whole tournament thing. It's going to be a blast, man.
Yeah,
I love Doom. Like, Doom is it's consistently like one of my top three favorite, most important games. Not even favorite, most important games of my life. So to be a part of this is this is awesome.
It's actually, because I was there, right? Somehow that came to me to do that. You know what I mean? I was like, Jack's kind of the Doom guy. And they're like, oh, no, well, we worked it out and this and that. And, you know, we wanted you to do it without COVID.
No, but we like you.
Well, and it's like, you know, I mean, like, especially with COVID, like, we've done a lot together.
Yeah, that's true.
That makes sense, and stuff like that. And, you know, I was like, okay. Like, Jack was the first person I mentioned. And then we were there the day we were shooting that promo trailer. And I was talking to Nadia, who works in sales, and she kind of, like, you know, helped set the thing up. And she was talking about hosting and this and that. And I was like, yeah, and, you know, initially I kind of said maybe Jack should do it, but they said they want to use me and this and that. And she goes, well, is Jack a good host? I was like, are you kidding me? Like, that's his thing. Like, that's what he does. Like, Jack should absolutely host it if it's an option. She goes, well, Tyler's hosting it, so do you think he'd work well with Tyler? And I was like, I think he'd be fine. Yeah.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I think
Sportsball with Tyler.
could really pull something out of that.
Yeah.
And I'm like, fucking, if there's anybody that knows Doom, it's Jack.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's cool that we get to go.
Yeah, it's going to be a blast. We're going to have fun. And we're staying near the Waffle, so we can go get
Waffle.
I'm so
what Jack
excited
said.
For the Waffle.
I was talking about the hotel, and I'm like, do you know what hotel we're staying in? Do you know how close it is to the airport? Because I'm leaving early on
He's
Wednesday.
He's like, no, but the Waffle.
That's literally what he said. He's like, no, I think it's actually pretty far downtown, but it's right next to the Waffle. All right.
Very, very
cool.
Happy
that'll,
for that.
That'll get me home.
Jack,
on time.
I get that, Jack.
Yeah,
of
absolutely. Course. Yeah.
Red Velvet Waffle. Not anyone would get that.
Fantastic.
But I'm really looking forward to it.
I can't wait to see that, man.
Oh, dude.
Especially with you guys hosting. It's going to be so
It's
going to
be a
funny,
blast. Like. Yeah. And it's just like, and it's the response is amazing. And like Terry Henry, that dude was like the football or soccer player.
One of the best in the world at the time.
And like people like, I mean, to me, I'm like Rob Gronkowski. Oh my God, that's so awesome. And then reading comments, people are losing their mind about Terry.
Right. Well, someone put it great. I mean, they're all super famous, world-class athletes, but like somebody put it in, I mean, because you can't, I mean, like, you know, soccer is, you know, the most popular sport in the world. Mm-hmm. And somebody was talking about like, dude, like, I'm not trying to say the other athletes aren't, you know, super well-known, because they are super well-known, but somebody was talking about their Facebook likes.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And they were like, I don't remember exactly who was where, but they were like, this person has 800,000 Facebook likes. This person has 1.3 million. This person has 1.9 million. Theory has 8.5 million Facebook likes. Like, holy shit.
Football and soccer is by far, like, the most
like,
popular sport
huge.
In the world. Like,
I don't even know if Gavin knows yet.
Yeah, yeah.
That he's on
so,
a...
So he played for Arsenal, and I think he played
the
World Cup for France, I want to say? I should look this up before I host the show?
Yeah, but it's not Doom, so it's okay.
So whose team is he on? He's on Ijustine?
He's with Sniper
Wolf. No, he's with Sniper Wolf.
Oh, Sniper Wolf.
Yeah.
Sniper Wolf.
Yeah, and so you and Gronk, and then it's Antonio.
People are really excited
Michael
about.
And Gronk's my favorite.
Dude, is that, when people are saying Mogar and Gronk, I just want to see that side by side.
That cannot be a spinoff of X-Men. Yeah.
Gronk is a giant.
Yeah, he is a big dude. I mean, that guy, he's like 6'5", 6'6", something like that. Jesus. And he's just enormous. Yeah. And he's like a party guy, too, but he's really, really smart in that he's taking... Well, he's taking all this salary and he's investing it and he's saving this money. He's actually really, really smart. And all of his appearance fees and stuff, that's what he plays, he has fun with, is just his appearance fee stuff. So he's like, you know, he's lined up to play for, you know, a decade and then be done and like live the rest of his life however he wants.
Yeah. Yeah. And well, before awesome, he's like a destroyed human.
Oh,
I'm retired and now I have 2 years still to live.
Get him with Gronk and then bring him in for Let's
I'm going to try. I'm going to try.
He seems like the guy that I think out of all of the players, like Antonio Brown sounds awesome, Thierry sounds awesome, Gronk seems like the one that I'd be like, dude, come to Austin, we're going to play some video games.
Well, it's funny because he tweeted about it. Gronk tweeted about it. And he was like, I'm sending Ochocinco to hell. In the fight like hell, because that's the hashtag fight like hell. And I was thinking about him like, yeah, I'm not gonna say that to him.
No fucking
way in hell I'm gonna tell Ochocinco to like, you're going to hell.
Yeah.
I'll be like, get him, Gronk. Get it.
Go get him, buddy. You do it. Go ahead.
I'll be back here.
But do we
need a controller?
Did they announce what time it's streaming on Tuesday?
I don't think so.
I want to say it's like 5 or 6 central. I don't know for sure. You should look that up watch it on Tuesday. Absolutely watch it on Tuesday. But look at the specific time when it does come out. I don't know. Yeah, but anyway, that trailer was awesome. I love it. How much did Lindsay freak out about the kittens?
Oh, dude, she was mad.
She was mad.
I said to Adam, I didn't even know about it. Like, I was there. I'm like, what are we doing? And they were like, oh, we got kittens.
What is it?
What is it?
5 p.m. Central. 5 p.m. Central on Tuesday. So that's 6 Eastern or 3 o'clock on the West Coast. So
nice.
Watch it live.
So I find out, I'm going to get covered in kittens. And they were like 5 weeks old. They're super tiny Siamese. I think they're Siamese cats.
Yeah, those look Siamese.
And their eyes were like...
Good job.
Their eyes were like crystal blue. You know, like
They're just so blue.
And, I mean, it was... They were so new to life. They weren't even like scrambling or anything. They were just like sitting there. They just kept trying to climb
into my
jacket.
This is what living is.
Yeah, basically. They just kept climbing into my jacket for warmth. And they had to keep pulling them out of my jacket. But I'm going over to film that, and I turned to Adam Kovic. I was like, hey, can you film this? Lindsay's gonna be pissed. And he's like, what do you mean? She's gonna be mad if you don't take pictures? I go, no, she's gonna be mad because of the picture. She's going to be angry.
Covered in kittens.
For 2 reasons. One, she's not here and it's not her. And 2, she knows I don't care. You know? Like, it was cool, but I'm like, oh, cool, cats. And like my shtick in the trailer is like, I don't know what the hell is happening because there's like crazy shit exploding. It's like, and kittens. And I'm kind of like confused. Even still, that would have been my reaction. Like, all right, I mean, there's cats on me.
Yeah.
So the first thing, like, you know, I get done with it and he gives me my phone. And Adam took, I think, 87 photos. And then he filmed the actual viewfinder of the camera. Like, I think it took up 10% of my storage on my phone.
To be fair, I would prefer that over the one guy who takes one photo that's blurry.
It is digital. Yeah, yeah. It is digital. Okay. I mean, you can delete everything. Yeah. But, like, 98% of them were perfectly acceptable.
Yeah.
But, yeah, like, her first response was like, what? Damn it. You don't even care.
Yeah.
You don't care.
You don't understand.
Michael is really good at predicting what people are going to say.
Holy shit.
You did it today.
We should mention that. So, for our own hubris and ego, it's just like a thing we've had a conversation in the office.
So we started
the Achievement Hunter YouTube channel, and Jeremy in the past few months was slated to, I say Jeremy because he made the video, to hit the first 1 million view video on the Achievement Hunter YouTube channel, which is one of his Fallout videos he did, which was how to find the alien gun. It's like 987,000 right now, or
right
something
like
that.
Right now, it's
989. It's 989.
It's like over that.
And I was one video behind
that.
I was one video, I was the video behind that with Rage Quit. To Explain is like 977,000. And I was like, oh, Jeremy, you know, that's cool. You're going to get the first 1 million view video on the channel. And he was kind of like, oh, yeah, you know, that's cool. That's cool. But, you know, kept it simple. And then Gavin, I think it was yesterday, put out, if not 2 days ago, put out the Hitman things to do that he filmed. I can't remember what it's called.
The Puddle Pile?
Yes, Puddle Pile. Where he...
Which is currently at 950,941 views.
Right.
There's
so,
Puddle Pile.
So,
in like 2 days, though.
It's a video in the new Hitman where basically you can rig this this lighting stand to electrocute people when they investigate it. And he keeps doing it over and over and over again and builds a pile of like dozens and dozens and dozens of bodies. And it's very funny. So that got posted to, I think, the front page of at least gaming or somewhere on Reddit.
Or something, yeah.
And it's blown the fuck up. So all of a sudden, cool, calm, and collected Jeremy is like, fuck you. Don't pass me to a million. And Gavin has been pretty smug about it in particular. Oh, yeah. So
it's Gavin,
of course.
Yeah.
So Jeff made a journal entry today basically explaining that, saying like, hey, funny little insight into the Achievement Hunter office. This is what the guys are all talking about right now. You know, who's going to be the first one to get to a million? I was convinced it was going to be Jeremy. But I'd even said in the past, like a month, 2 months ago, I said, your video is going to be the first video to hit a million views unless it's a video that hasn't been made yet.
Yeah.
And now that's Gavin's video.
Yeah.
Right? I'm like, I don't think Ragequit's going to hit it. I doubt it'll get, you know, a bump out of nowhere. But now Gavin is clearly on course to pass Jeremy.
The trajectory.
So basically Jeff just made a whole journal entry about it and was like, hey, if you want to help somebody win, go check this person out. So that Gavin didn't want Jeff to do that.
Because Gavin knows
if he lets nature take its course,
he's got it.
On Reddit, he's got it. If it goes to the Rooster Teeth website and Jeff makes a journal entry, my prediction was people are going to be like, no, Lil J's the new guy. It's the new channel. He's going to be the first one to get to a million. I want him to get to a million. And Gavin, knowing this, is like, I don't think you should do it. I'm just, you know, I'm just saying, you know, why do we gotta poke things? Why do we gotta touch it? And I go, and Jeremy said something along the lines of like, no, but they might pick Gavin for this reason. And I said, they won't pick Gavin, most people. And within the first few comments, here's what someone will say. Jeff said in the journal entry, who will claim the title of smuggest prick in the office between me, Jeremy, and Gavin? And what I said to Jeff was, I'm glad you put that in there, because in the first few comments, someone is gonna say, Gavin's already a smug prick, so Jeremy, I hope Jeremy wins and I'm gonna watch his video. The first fucking comment. I think it was 8 seconds after Jeff entered it. The first comment was, Gavin's already a smug prick, so I hope Lil J wins, or something along the lines of that. And I just lost it. I was like, yes! I was like, I'm so good at this!
You called your shot. That was amazing.
So good!
So far, I haven't seen any changes yet. It's still Gavin's at 950, and the Alien Blaster thing's at 989.
Such a piece of shit conversation, which normally we wouldn't talk about, like, on the podcast. In the room, of course, because all we talk about is ourselves. But, because Jeff found amusement. Jeff said, I think the smuggest prick, actually, before that was, Jeff's like, honestly, I don't give a shit who wins, but I do give a shit about who loses.
that was really his comment.
So, you know, go decide. Who do you think's gonna hit 2 million first? You've got
1 million.
I just
want to take a step back real quick. I was just checking Twitter to see what's going on. So it's Thierry Henry. Not Henry, Thierry Henry,
gotcha.
And we should probably make sure to say
that's
that.
That's true, but there is an H.
There is an
it's
H.
It's just silent.
It looks like Henry, but it's gotcha. Henry because he's French, and he played for the French national team. So, and Arsenal,
as well.
And Arsenal, Barcelona, Juventus, and then for New York Red Bull.
Jeremy.
So that was his final one. So.
Jeremy.
Oh, he's been around.
Well, it's okay.
So thank you, Justine, and everyone else who corrected it for me before I make an ass out of
that's
myself
good.
On
that's
the live
good.
Stream.
That's good that it came before Doom.
Yeah. I'm sure he's watching the off-topic podcast
he's
right now.
He's furious.
Yeah, he's just sitting there, you know, in his mansion.
Dude, he's
going
to send 8.4 million Facebook likes your way.
Yeah.
He's going to come at you hard.
And Ojo Cinco are on the couch together watching it.
I'm sending you to hell!
So thank you very much, Internet, for correcting us. The Internet shockingly enjoys correcting people. Did you know that?
No,
it's okay when they're right.
Yeah, that's
okay
actually appreciated.
That.
Yeah, they like correcting people, speaking for a large group of people who are okay with that. Yeah, you know, things along those lines. Open letters to us.
Yeah. Man.
right. I forgot about that. That was another one.
Oh, yeah.
So that was like, another great post.
Real quick, going back to the logo, I won't get into details of it, but someone posted something, I think, on the subreddit and said, this is an open letter to Achievement Hunter. Jeff was telling me about it. I didn't read it. But it was a long post, basically, about how, like, the intros are ruining everything, and the Achievement Hunter's doomed because of the intros.
Makes the fans sad.
That's what
I read it.
It was, like, ruining, literally, the intros were ruining the fan base and making us sad, and they didn't even know why we were doing that to them. And I think it was posted either yesterday or today, and we're talking about, like, the turn. Jeff said in 15 comments, every single comment was, like, fucking Christ, guy. Like, come on. And then he just deleted it.
Yeah.
It's just like, Jesus, it's a fucking picture.
Yeah, okay. Did you know that that's what Elton watched for? They watched for the intro and nothing else.
Oh,
intro,
like, that's the guy with the guy with the tattoo right there.
Yeah. He was only don't get a tattoo. This is why we tell people that. Okay? It's not that we don't like it, but, like, we're not Disney, okay? It's going to change.
Yeah.
Right?
Even Disney changes. Yeah. Mickey looks completely different from the beginning.
It's true, but I mean the ears. Are you get the ears, pretty, that's good.
Have you ever seen, like,
they change his ears, you're all fucked.
Have you seen the old Mickey costumes where it's like, looks like someone who would murder you?
Yes.
Like, oh, like, absolutely. Like
what's next?
Like Five Nights.
Yeah. Like really messed up ones that are like, spooky. Yeah.
Changing graphics. Is good. When I saw Pepsi change their logo, I was just in the store. I was like, cunt!
Oh, really? Because usually what I did was, I remember the first time I saw they changed the design for Mountain Dew. I just went, ah! And I screamed at it in the
just
store.
Threw it in the air.
Yeah. No!
Punching.
No!
You see the big display, you just go tackling.
No!
You climb like the tower of soda cans.
This doesn't tickle
people.
My innards.
Yeah.
Ram.
That was their slogan for a while, wasn't it?
Tickle your innards.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Do the do. That was up for a bit there as well.
Yeah.
I've done it.
No, there you go. There's Creepy Mickey. Look at Creepy Mickey.
Oh, my God.
Minnie looks worse.
It looks like they put Pluto's face on the center of his face.
Hey, kids!
Look how fucking close together his eyes are.
What do you dream about?
Welcome to the happiest place on Earth.
Have you met any pirates? Sorry.
Did you see Walt Disney, like, comforting the child? No, it won't kill you. It's okay.
Don't worry about it.
Plus, on top of that, imagine that costume with
God! Why would you do that?
Zoomed in.
And you can see the person's face in the eye.
It looks like somebody hit him in the face with a fucking fire axe.
Oh, Jesus.
Also,
his lips were splitting apart.
Yeah. Imagine that costume character doing the Steamboat Willie dance. Like,
his eyes, like, they're kind of fucked up, so one's just like,
yeah.
No, they're kind of, oh, God!
Jesus.
They're kind of fucked up, so one is just always looking at you.
Yeah.
Even if the other one waves.
I don't like it. I don't like it at all.
Jesus.
Yeah. That God. Was that oh
happiest God. Place on Earth though.
How'd I get blood on my suit? I use lemon juice! I ate Pluto! It'll wash it out!
It's just seeping out of me.
Good times.
I'm glad you brought that up, Jack.
Oh my God. Yeah, that's terrifying, man. And now the new ones, they have eyes that actually blink.
I know. That's
oh my God.
Right?
Their mouths talk and their eyes blink.
Or is it just,
I have no idea.
No. They're robots.
It's like a Titan.
Yeah.
They're in there like.
Oh man.
Jack's like, so tiny. I don't know how they work. I don't know if they're Zoids. Are they alive? Do you just pilot them?
What it is the kids that used to be in the Small World ride. They've gotten to the age
they're in
they
the
have
suit.
To. Yeah. They're in the suit piloting it.
I like to think that it's just actually a giant Mickey, and every now and again he goes to the least like. They don't believe I'm real.
He goes to the frozen head of Walt.
He's like, I'll fucking show him.
He's like, what am I?
I'll show him.
He goes to the frozen head of Walt. He's just like, Walt, today's the day. They'll believe.
What, he goes to his grave?
No, the frozen head that they keep wearing.
Oh, yeah, that's what they do with
him. Dude, I'll
tell you, if you could see the people inside those costumes, you would not want your kids getting When I worked there, like, I worked at the Great Movie Ride in their break room, because they would come out in front of our attraction and, like, do, you know, whatever shows and stuff. And their break room was on our second floor of our building, and so we'd see them all the time. They are the weirdest, creepiest people ever.
Well,
and
I mean,
it's like, no.
I mean, like, you don't really think about it. I don't know, Disney World or whatever. Who else would they put in the costume?
Yeah, exactly.
You know, they're like, oh, God, put this on your fucking head.
98-degree weather in a costume?
You animal.
Dude, that being said, those people work, like, 15 minutes per hour. Like, they would go out, sign autographs, and then leave and take a break for 45 minutes.
Well, I'm sure.
Because they don't want to overheat. But it's like, that's, like, the sweetest job ever.
It's also why they get all the beautiful people to be, like, the princes and princesses that walk around.
Those are called face characters. When you actually see someone's face.
Yeah,
so,
I've said before that for 2 years in high school, I was in a marching band. I was in a high school band.
I'm marching band.
Marching band.
Would you play?
the Mickey Mouse costume.
Trumpet? Dude, I played trumpet.
Did you?
Fourth through seventh grade. Yeah, never any good.
So freshman, sophomore year, I played the trumpet in the marching band, and we went to Disney World to play in their parade.
Sweet.
Fuck that. Like, I was walking down whatever they call it. Disney I guess Lane. Main Street, they call it in Disney World. Like, you know, in
Main Street,
Disney
USA. World,
in Magic Kingdom or whatever. Like, you would stop playing, you go, and just sweat would fly off your head. And we walked through Tomorrowland, like, you know, Tomorrowland's one of the places there. Yeah. There was a fucking dancing trash barrel, and I know there was. And no one else saw it. They thought I was just suffering from heat stroke. I swear to God, in Futureland or whatever it's called, Tomorrowland, the trash barrel was dancing. It had legs, and it kicks. And
that's
it goes
shocking.
Like
usually it's so cool and dry in Florida.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. We have like eight layers on.
Not humid at all.
I've been to Florida twice, and it's just like.
Yeah.
And then there was one thing I agreed to do where they're like, this guy's a saxophone solo at one point, right? You and this other dude are gonna lift him up on your shoulders.
Oh, nice.
Right? And then he plays, and you're dancing around playing, and then like holding.
You're holding him dancing and playing the trumpet?
And it sucked.
How many? Were you Goro at the time?
No, you can do a trumpet with one hand. You hold it like that, you got the.
I mean, physically, sure. Yeah, I'm saying not
dude.
Well.
But also. Also, what I didn't anticipate is I'm me, the other guy holding him up
I'm gonna
is
assume
like 5'9. Yeah,
right.
Like,
yeah.
Like, so the dude's like this on top
so
of
the guy's
us,
got
right?
his dick on somebody.
Like, are there photos of this somewhere?
Yeah, I think so.
Dude, I want to see those photos.
I'll try
to find that. That could be an Extra Life thing.
See, the thing is, like, it's crazy because I'm sure there are photos of it somewhere, but it's so before the time of, like, Jeremy Dooley. Like, it'd be damn near impossible to find. You'd have to, like, find someone who has the photo and is a fan now.
Meanwhile, though, people are still looking
is.
For that dancing trash barrel. They're going to find it.
They exist.
They'll probably find that before Jeremy.
Literally, we stopped. We, like, got to the end, stopped playing. I was like, did you see the trash barrel? They were like, Jeremy, you need to sit down.
Glass over, pouring sweat.
No, seriously.
They're like pulling you out.
No, it's real. I swear it's real.
I see a dance behind the back, and I'm like, oh, there he goes.
Mickey shows up. He's like, shh, just dreams now.
The old Mickey. In the closet with the old
with
Mickey.
With his chloroform glove.
Yeah.
Dude, I gotta say, like, every now and then.
Oh, it's
you
a
would
gas
see, like,
that comes out.
Oh, that was a dancing. Look at it. There's a dancing trash barrel.
There he is. That was him.
Oh, my God. I literally said they'd find it before your photo. They found it in 18 seconds.
I was watching the trash barrel move around and shit. I'm like, because it was like going with the music, it was doing this.
I gotta say, one of my favorite times when I was working there is every now and then they would bust out old costumes for whatever reason. I saw Darkwing Duck pop up. I'm like, oh my
That's
god,
awesome.
Darkwing
Dude,
Duck?
Cool.
And then like the Power Rangers would show up every now and then. It's like, how did
the
that
Power
work?
Are they owned by Disney?
I don't know, but they were there.
Fucking the Power Rangers are at Disney.
I mean, who knows how it works? Power Rangers were Bandai, at least.
When I watched it fucking 20 years ago.
Yeah. But it was fun. Like, I don't know, working there was an experience, man. That's if you can do it, if you can work in a theme park,
I just
want to
go
for
there
it.
Again.
I went when I was 2.
Yeah.
No, go now.
I don't remember it.
Yeah, that was also the cruel thing when you see like kids who don't want to be there, very clearly don't want to be there, and then the parents who spent so much money just dragging their children, we're going on the rides.
Yeah.
And just,
I mean, I'm sure I was fine. I just don't remember
or
it.
Or kids, because
my brothers.
Not gonna remember it.
I was saying, my brothers were eight and 11.
That's fair enough.
You know, so it was more like for them, and it's like, we can't leave the asshole. 2-year-old at home, but I just have obviously no memory of anything.
Don't
tell a kid
who isn't going to remember it there. Don't spend all the money.
It's not worth it.
But that's just put them in a box. They'll remember
that
the same way.
It doesn't cost anything.
Make some noise.
It doesn't cost anything to bring a fucking 2-year-old.
There's no charge.
It costs something to bring yourself.
You say that because my sister is taking my 2 nephews, my 4 and 2-year-old nephews, going like in a couple months. So it's like,
we also
can't imagine
took a fucking bus
to Florida.
Yeah. From Jersey to Florida.
Oh, God.
There was a toilet on the bus, and it was like, I mean, again, I don't remember.
It just goes onto the road.
It was like a 20-30 hour bus ride or some shit.
My God.
Yeah.
Nope.
No, thank you.
Yeah. Like, I don't even know how it worked. Like, because we didn't stop, so I don't know if they, like, switched off drivers or what.
They tag out.
Like, I don't know.
Just doing trucker meth.
Yeah. But I think we just went right there.
Oh, my
but,
God.
But, yeah, it was, like, of course, super fucking cheap. It was, like, part of the package and bring your whole stupid family and ride the bus with all the other stupid cheap families. And we did it. We did it real well.
Nice. I went, like, when I was, like, 21, I think. We
wow,
went
brag
there.
About it.
And we went to, what you do is you go to Epcot. And then you go around, because Epcot has all the different countries,
you
right?
Drink around the world.
You drink around the world. So you go to each place, you get a drink. Then you go onto Soarin', which is the ride that has a big screen and you're like flying over it and make it look like, which is narrated by Patrick Warburton.
That's awesome.
So the whole time I was in the thing drunk on Swarm and all the other people, I'm going, all right, cadets, and then we'll land over here. There's oranges, blah, blah, blah. And so it's like the greatest moment in my life.
Yeah, that's so drinking around the world. So what you do, like, you can either start in Mexico or you can start in Canada. Because initially, I know way too much about
The U.S.
Initially,
is the center
it was
of the
world. No, it was literally going to start with the U.S. and then go from there.
Much like the sun.
But then they moved the U.S. to the other end, so you have to walk through everything to get to the U.S. So they, that,
it's
they
worth
literally,
it, though.
That's why they did
just
it.
Go to the U.S.
And so
you have to trudge through the shit to get to the promised land,
basically.
And so you
said Disney.
Yeah, not me.
So,
Disney.
What did say? Why the fuck would you even visit those other countries? We're right here. You're already here.
Donald Trump says build a wall.
I say not hard enough.
Let's go on, little Jack.
Oh, my God. So the question is, do you start with the Labatt Blue or do you start with the margarita? And or which one do you end on? So I like to end on the margarita. It's always nice.
When you get to
taste.
Germany, that's the fun one.
Oh yeah.
Stein.
They do a wine festival too, where they add in more countries, and you can't even make it.
They just make them up.
You can't even make it to the U.S. Like Wine-topia. You can just get hammered by the time you're there. Although
Pinot Noiricon or whatever.
Although I will say, being drunk at a theme park is one of the most fun experiences you'll ever.
You're like, Mickey's fake! And all the kids walking by.
And then the robot Mickey, no, I'm not! I'll show Jack!
It was probably like 2013, I think. Me, Lindsay, her cousin, I think Barbara was there, and Andrew, Andy, the AH intern. We went to the Six Flags in San Antonio over the summer.
Oh, yeah.
And me growing up in Jersey, like I was 40 minutes from Great Adventure. So I'd go there all the time, and growing up, it was like standard protocol of leave super early, go to the sub shop, you know, like the quick check, get subs, put them in the cooler, get drinks, go to Six Flags, be there for a couple hours, go out to the parking lot, eat your sandwiches, they're way better than the food there, and it's fucking way cheaper,
super cheap.
And then you go back in. So everyone else is blown away by this, as I mentioned this, like, well, let's get subs, and they're like, that's the greatest fucking idea ever in history. I'm like, right. But what I also did was I made a jug of Riot Punch. I put it in a cooler bag and filled ice in the bag and just left it in the car all day. We didn't touch it all day. When we came out to lunch, we started drinking it.
Oh, no.
At lunch, maybe we spent 30, like I just opened the tailgate in the car, the back of the car, and we just like, there's no tailgate, but we just ate in the back of the car. And maybe 30 minutes later, Andrew was so drunk, he was lying on the parking lot floor, face down.
Nice.
So we go back into the park, and he's fucking wasted. And the first thing he does is he plays that game where it's like that wobbly rope.
Oh, yeah,
and you
gotta
climb.
Oh, no!
I think you have to take your shoes off
and
climb up to the end of the rope, and he must have tried it like 6 times. And he was just so drunk. It was so fucking funny watching
awesome.
Him get on like the first step and fall off. It's like, another $5, another $5, another $5. It was fantastic watching him be drunk.
Dude,
in that
the last
park.
Time I went to Disney, I used it to get revenge on my dad.
Weird.
Because when I was really little. When I was really little, they took me to Disney World, right? Like me and my sister and stuff. My dad took me on a ride that's not there anymore. It's called Alien Extinction.
Alien Encounter.
Alien Encounter, that's it. They
get your shit straight.
They turned it into like a Lilo and Stitch
ride. Yeah, it's 636, or Stitch's Escape, I think.
Stitch's Escape. Because what it is now is there's a tube in the middle of the room. You all sit there with like these straps over you. And Stitch is in the tube. And then like he escapes and the lights go out.
Oh shit, just like in the movie.
Right.
Yeah.
You can feel him like jumping on you and stuff like that. It's like, oh,
like blows in your ear.
Yeah, and like burps on you. You're like, oh, I love Stitch. What the ride used to be is there was a fucking like demon alien thing in the tube in front of you, and he bashes out of the thing. The lights all go out, and there's people like, oh god, he's loose. Wait, what? Why does he have fucking wings? And he's like flying around the room and breathing on you and shit. And I was like 6. And my dad's like, no, I'll be fine. I'll be great, right?
Absolutely.
So then I'm terrified of the dark for the next like 8 years. Then we go to Disney World, like when I'm in my 20s and stuff. My dad's in his 50s or whatever. And I'm like,
whatever, my dad.
I'm like, I'm putting this asshole on the Tower of Terror.
Oh, nice.
He hates it. So we take him on. We're like, yeah, Dad, you just go through this thing, and like, oh, yeah, there's a whole alien encounter. Oh my God, look at that thing!
Yeah, that thing is terrifying.
It's like, and I'm like seven, right? And he's just like, oh hell, I'm gonna eat you.
this is the old one. This is the new one.
Yeah, now it's happy one. Now it's happy little Stitch in there, right? Yeah, the glass shatters.
They still try to scare the shit out of you, but it's like, oh, it's just Stitch. So who cares?
It's like, I'm startled, but it's fun.
Like the bars float over your shoulders, so they like hit you to simulate that he's like near you and stuff. And
guy doesn't come out and slap you around.
Right? Yeah, he like blows wind on you, like he's breathing on you. But anyway. So I tell my dad, I'm like, yeah, you just ride through. It's like this little, like, you know, haunted mansion thing. It's funny. And then you just drop once and then you get off. And he's like, fine. You don't drop once. You drop like four or five times on the Tower of Terror. So I get on that thing. We get to the top. And he's sitting next to me. He's like, I fucking hate you for this. I hate you for this. Like, I hate drops. I'm like, oh, no, it'll be fine. The thing opens, right? You see the park. And you drop. And, like, so he's screaming. And then it goes all the way back up to the top. And the whole way he's going, what's happening? What are you doing? What are you doing? What's going on with me?
I'm controlling everything.
He gets to the top. The door opens again. He sees it again. And he goes, Jeremy, you fun! And drops again. We just kept doing it.
Dude. Yeah,
it's that, like having a heart attack. I loved it.
The Tower of Terror is awesome. Like, because what that does, you know, a lot of those rides you see, they drop and that's it, you know? That one goes up and down, and at one point it'll go down and then go up and then start going down as it's coming up. So you literally float above your seat for like a good second or two.
It's
really awesome.
That one's fun.
Hell on you if you got hemorrhoids.
Yeah.
Don't want to ride that. That
one's awesome. And the one right next door to it is the Rock and Roller Coaster, the Aerosmith
Roller Coaster. That's fucking
awesome. That is probably
the
best ride. That's probably the best ride.
Ken Marino's on that ride.
I was gonna say, Jeremy gave me a ride to work today.
Yeah,
it's funny because he mentioned like him and his dad as well. And
I sure did.
I can't remember exactly how he got onto it or whatever, but we were talking about like working out and going to the gym and this and that, because that's what we do. We bro out, you know.
Yeah,
we were just like
you
fighting
live
each
today,
other.
You live.
We were just fighting each other the whole time while he was driving here.
Just drinking protein shakes.
And he said something along the lines of about like going home or something, and I'm like, oh,
you were talking about your brother, and that's what brought.
That's right. My brother's a big fat fuck, and I was mentioning that.
That was the term.
It was because he is, and it was like this conversation where I'm like, I talk to my mother a lot, and she works out, you know, because she wants to get in shape before she's an old piece of shit, because then it's too late, you know. So I was like, I talked to her back and forth about that, and it's like this conversation about me going to the gym, and then she's like, oh, I'll send you a picture of your brother, and then she goes, he said he couldn't take a picture because he would put you to shame. And I was like, that's funny because he's a fat fuck and he's out of shape. So I'm talking to Jeremy about it, and he goes, yeah, you know, this and that, like, I'll get that when I go home. And I don't know really what I expected, maybe like his mother or something of like, I thought he was gonna say he goes home and like, oh, you put on weight or something like that. But Jeremy's like, yeah, go home. My dad will be like, been going to the gym? What was the example you used?
I'll go home and my dad would be like, oh, did you lose some weight? I'm like, yeah, I lost a little bit of weight. And he'd be like, oh, that's a good start. And like, that. He's in such better shape than I am. It's ridiculous. Like, I told Michael, like, when the P90X things came out, he instantly got that, like all the tapes that like show all this stuff.
Right.
And then he keeps moving up. And I was not lying when I said I think his new one's called Hammer and Sickle.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Like
that's
that.
What you said.
Like Hammer's like building muscle and Sickle's like abs or something, you know? I'm like, so he's always like doing all this shit. My sister like teaches those Zumba classes and stuff like that. So like I go home and I'm like, I've been working out. They're like, get out of here. What are you doing?
They lift you up and just throw you out.
My friends used to watch, like we would go to my house after school and my dad would sit on the couch like after he'd been working out or whatever. And he's like reading the paper and he just goes. Like while he's reading the paper and stuff like that. And like while we're on vacation and stuff, he'll be like, see that? There's a line there now. I can see both of those.
That's
muscles.
Awesome.
Oh my God. Shut up. I know it.
Jeremy had a comment that was something like, he's like, my dad's in way better shape than me. He's always going on about I need to work out more, blah, blah, blah. And he goes, I'm just lucky he's an old bitch, so I can take him. I was like, just push him over and run away.
Exactly. It's like a hot rod, like you just bring your dad.
Exactly.
Apparently, that's what it's like. Yeah. He comes home and he just starts fighting him.
He beats him, he can stay in the house for a little while longer.
Yeah. The Boston way. You know,
it is,
makes sense.
It's like a greet, it's like a handshake.
It's just a punch
just
to the
face. Fight.
Yeah.
Right.
Nice.
That's how it works.
God, I would be afraid to fight you. I think you would be scrappy. Like, I imagine you
I'm tough to knock down because I've got a low center of gravity.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Remember that thread from like a week ago that was like,
who would win?
Seriously, like just asking, in a dead serious fist fight, who would win, Jeremy or Jeff? And I was like, why? Why would they be fist fighting each other? Like, what does that mean?
I just walk in, I'm like, fuck you, Jeff!
And they just start fighting, just beating the shit out of each other. Yeah. That was the whole thread. And it's like, oh, well, I don't know, you know, because Jeremy works out more, and I feel like he's got more physical strength. Well, then you can't count out Jeff, because, you know, Jeff seems pretty wily, too, and he was in the Army, so you gotta remember, you know, he did go through basic
like
training.
A ton of legitimate
like,
replies.
People are, like, making fucking cards and giving them stats and shit and, like, playing with each other.
It's actually
it's
the next,
like, what are you doing?
It's the next Screw Attack Death Battle. It's gonna be, it's gonna be Jeff versus Jeremy.
In, but in real life.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
That's it. Just one will die.
Like, we're not animating this, just fight.
That would be amazing. Can you walk into work one day and just go, hey, Jeff, fuck you! That would be incredible.
I did do something like that recently.
I would just start clapping.
Yeah.
I don't know if it got into the video, but we recorded a Let's Watch in Quantum Break. And so we had the camera rolling and we had the audio going and everything like that. But then Michael and Adam Kovic were both in the room. And you guys have been drinking, like, off doing something. Oh, it was off topic. You came in after off topic.
Sure.
So you guys, like, just kept talking to each other and blah, blah, blah. Jeff was jumping in and stuff, but we were already rolling and I was, like, trying to get the thing. So Jeff starts talking, and I go, please shut the fuck up! Like, I yelled at everybody. And Jeff then called me Ray and moved on. No.
Oh, look at this.
Hey. Oh,
look at this smug prick.
On here.
Puddle pile.
You smug it? Hey, Gavin, have you happened to check any views, or?
Oh, is it done?
I don't know.
Is it over?
No, I don't.
I'm asking.
I don't
know. I'm asking you, Gavin, we're on the podcast.
All the people who would know.
We were here!
You went to lunch? It was like 11 o'clock.
What are you getting? A third cup that you're still not going to finish?
Well, I'm not. I know I'm going to finish, so I'm just going to give myself that much.
Well, I appreciate if you actually finish it. That's I thank
you. I don't know how.
Usually you're like full glass sip and I'll leave.
I got 952 on Puddle Pile right now.
It's a waste.
952.
Hey, there's a photo. We were talking about it earlier. Look how good you look. Look at that.
Oh, look at Kevin.
Look at the camera. It looks just like you.
Look at that photo.
My favorite part is, like, we talked about that 40 minutes ago.
Yeah, they had it loaded.
They
must have
been saving it. Like, they knew you were coming.
They had it queued up for you.
Spidey sense.
Beautiful resemblance.
It's the least flattering one that there is.
Gavin, you sit here for a second. I'm gonna use the restroom.
Oh, wait, I just saw them scroll.
There you go, there you go. Look, zoom in pants. Zoom in pants.
You have lost, like, prominent teeth, man.
And they're not even like, they didn't just fall out. Like, it looks like you have fangs left.
Yeah. How would I even knock out both of those without knocking out the middle one? It doesn't even
make sense.
Very precise
knock.
If you get hit with a flat blade screwdriver in the tooth, it could knock just one out.
That'd be brutal.
The first guy to get hit by that was named Philip. And that's how they got the name of the screwdriver.
Really? The guy got hit with a flat blade screwdriver and then he
twice, but twice in the same spot,
one.
But they were at 90 degree angles.
Yeah.
Bang, bang! And he was
good
like,
to know.
I could make this.
Yeah, good to know.
It's like, ticked. Also, my name's Philip.
Yeah.
Philip's head.
That's still one of my favorite RVB lines in the history of RVB, with Tucker going, he must have had a fucked up head!
Was that him? Was a donut?
No, that was Tucker.
That was Tucker. That guy had a fucked up head.
One or two? Not even. Maybe it's later than that. I don't know. I think it's on the early end. I mean, you directed one. You should know. What is it?
Season three?
They
say it's when they're working on the Warthog, isn't it? It's Donut.
Oh, is it?
Yes!
Damn it.
Oh,
you got me.
You go out of your beat.
Yeah. Well, listen, I'm a dumb fan. That
yeah,
knows
you know all
it's true.
That.
It's true.
I watched them readjust the camera when I replaced
I fucking that. Hate Tucker. Never mind. He's my favorite. Even when he doesn't say things. But go ahead.
Well, I mean, like, Jack and I are different sizes, so it's funny they have to, like,
you are a different to, like, size human being, so that's accurate.
Is he, like, up like this?
It probably was.
I keep doing like this to the game.
Add, be more fat, too. That'd probably throw
Jack's
it off.
Jack's not even fat.
Jack's not fat
he's
anymore.
Not really.
No, I mean, no. The thing is, and I said this to Lindsay, right? Because she's like, well, even you yourself said Jack's not fat anymore. And I was like, right, but he's still the most fat as of now.
Oh,
right.
Yeah.
So he
I
can
mean,
still.
Fattest.
Right. Let's, I mean, hang on to it while we got it, right?
He said he runs like
he runs
5Ks
a lot. Running is good for fat people.
He well, gets people in general, but yeah,
it is.
For fat people.
No,
you're
I mean
right.
I don't run. Why the fuck would brutal. I run? I don't want to lose weight. I don't really do that much cardio.
You just don't enjoy treadmill or anything like that?
I mean, I also fucking hate running. Like, my legs suck, and I hate running.
Oh, yeah, you get, like,
he's
sore
got a
legs.
Treadmill now.
Yeah, well, tomorrow it gets
delivered. Oh, your treadmill shows up tomorrow?
Yeah.
And you broke yours, right?
But
I haven't fixed it yet. I'm so fucking lazy.
Pretty much the only time I use treadmill is before I work out. If I don't ride my bike. Like, sometimes I ride my bike to the gym, and then I don't even bother, because that's, like, a good warm-up.
Well, that's enough
heart hole
yeah,
going.
Just to get your heart hole going. Yeah. That's a good point. Get your blood pumping. And then I really don't use it at all.
Dude, if you can believe it, I used to be active.
And I don't believe it.
Yeah, I don't either.
Yeah.
I used to like go skateboarding and like, you know, do all that shit. Hacky sack.
Yeah.
Contemporary, like, you know, like you high school athlete. Shit.
Are you playing on the Doom thing? Are you on somebody's team?
Yeah, I actually am. I have like 800 million followers.
Is there a fifth hidden person?
Yeah. Ocho Cinco couldn't make it, so we replaced with
Matt Brown. Hacky sack is good.
Is that good?
I used to do that like every day. And that was like one of the most active things I did, because it was like one of those things where you juggle it, and I got up to like 200 one time, and I was like, holy shit.
Isn't the only point of hacky sack to juggle it?
That is.
Does anyone have one? I want to see this in action.
I don't have a hacky sack on me.
Does anybody have a sack?
Yeah, I'll use that.
All right, I'm out. See you later,
Gavin. Bye, Gavin. Dude.
Wait, did Matt say he hacky sack?
Yeah, he used to hacky sack. They said it's the most active thing he does.
Well, I used to skateboard too.
We were talking about how you run.
I broke my arm.
Oh, yeah.
I quit doing that.
Yes.
Now, Jack can probably run further than I can.
May have called you fat.
Me?
Dude, Jack, don't worry.
No. The conversation was, everyone agreed, like, but Jack's losing weight. And I was like, but he's the fattest for now, though. Yes. Like, let me have it. It's only going to last a little bit longer.
The thing is, Jack, like, you're losing weight. You're, like, working out and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
My metabolism's going to die.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to get...
You're going
to balloon, like, 100 pounds overnight.
I mean, that's what I always said about... I mean, we all said about Ray, too.
Yeah.
Because you and Ray had a very similar diet. I will say you're probably even worse than Ray. But of just, like... Super skinny, eats garbage, shit, nonsense, doesn't do anything, never moves, is super thin. And it's like, it's gonna run out. I mean, you get to work.
I get to work, that's basically it.
When you stand up and the chair goes with you, I'll be so happy. That'll be
But yeah, that's the thing though, is like, Jack, you'll work it off. Like, you're at some point, taking some like steps to do that. I will never do that.
My favorite Matt moment ever
was when we went to HEB to get lunch or something, and like, you were a little bit behind us, so I didn't see what you had gotten. Mm-hmm. Or, oh no, I went before you guys, you went with Trevor.
Yeah.
So I came back, I had like a sandwich, you know, like, because it's not that many calories and whatever. Trevor got like his little microwavable thing that he gets. Matt got a cookie pizza.
I ate half of it that day and then nibbled on the rest of it.
What is a cookie pizza?
Well, it's pretty obvious. It's in the name. It's a cookie shaped like a pizza. It's like a big cookie.
It's a cookie about this big.
It's more cookie than pizza.
Topped with icing and like other little toppings.
I'm thinking like, is there pepperoni on a cookie pizza?
No.
Like,
nope.
There were pretty little butterflies on it. Not because I like butterflies, but because that was the most icing you could get on the cookie pizza.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm glad Matt just wants to get that out there. Yeah. He doesn't like butterflies.
Well, butterflies, okay.
Let's clear the air. Butterflies, no. Icing, yeah.
I wanted the icing. I hate it. While I was eating it. I hated it. Dude, I want to point this out, because I brought it out last week, and a fair number of people mentioned it, or they saw it, but I forgot to mention it. So I got this sweet-ass new stool.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
Speaking of my fat fuck brother, he bought me this for Christmas. Love him to death. Salt of the earth. And he just, like, never got around to shipping it to me, because surprisingly I didn't bring the stool on the fucking plane
with me.
It's a Sweet Patty's Irish Pub stool. So I finally got it. I put it together. I figured I'd bring it into work. If it looks stupid on the set, I wasn't going to use it, because I don't know if it would, like, match with the other stuff.
Yeah.
I didn't want to make Marcus's beautiful set look like crap. But, I mean, it seems to work out pretty well. Added bonus, I get a comfy-ass seat.
Yeah, let's say you got a cushion.
I mean, you're welcome to bring your own seat, Jack.
Off topic, we'll give you okay? ass problems.
I'm just saying.
I'll drag over the Game
Dude,
of Thrones
Dude, can I bring
chair.
A seat that's, like, this high?
Yeah.
Yeah. You can do that if you get a bunch of like just seat
phone
cushions.
Books.
Yeah. I don't think that would be any more comfortable
no,
sitting on a series of
it
phone
would
books.
Not. But every now and again, I pull one out, rip it.
Yeah.
But it
just
might.
Just show off your dominance.
Yeah.
The only time I ever had like a sore bottom was week one of the podcast.
Oh, yeah.
It was like 2 days later, and I had that gym soreness, you know, where it's like a day or two later, and you're like, what is that?
I've been familiar with
that. Oh, yeah,
it
worked
lately.
Out. And I was like, what? Did something like go in my butt? Or I didn't notice it or something? The podcast, that's what it was.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I don't know. Things,
that's
crazier
the
things
worst.
Have happened. Since then, it was never a problem. I was kind of like, uh-oh. And then week 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe I've, like, calloused my ass, so it's fine.
You've worked your ass out.
But this is just swell. I mean, I could be here all day. And it spins. Look. Whee!
When your ass is sore, that sucks. Also, when you do that machine, because you did this a little while
ago. It's your ass and your inner thighs.
The one where you push the things together, right?
Yep.
It's just like your dick hurts. It's horrible.
You can use the machine wrong.
It's that area.
The problem.
It surrounds it.
The problem is, again, my dick didn't hurt, but it looks like you're all about your dick. Because it's like I was constantly just walking like, ah.
Oh, right, yeah.
Like that, because that's where it is. I don't know if you know the machine we're talking about.
Oh, yeah,
about.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
Got the one where you spread your legs in it, and then you squeeze your thighs together.
The one where you refuse to look at anyone while you're doing it, yeah.
Don't they have a reverse of that, too?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, it's the same machine. You just push them in, and then you push it out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dude, yeah, I'm learning and it's real so
much. Oh yeah, how's your treadmill? Have you talked
I don't
about
get
it.
You know, I was saying we get the treadmill tomorrow.
Oh okay. Yeah.
But I have so far. I have I just have like a chair, you know, like a workout chair. You can adjust the height, which is actually useful because I can already do sit-ups on it super easy because it's got like a little leg cushion, feet cushions, you know, so I can like pull myself up.
Nice.
And I put together the pull-up dip station that I have. So it's actually nice. I was telling Jeremy about it because Lindsay got here early this morning because you guys were filming in another theater mode.
Yep.
Check it out, coming soon.
What?
So we didn't go to work together. That's why Jeremy gave me a ride. So I went to the gym super early and I just drove back so she could take the car and come to work. So it's like the second I got back from the gym, which I wrapped it a little early, she was at the door waiting for me to come back. She hopped in the car and left. So usually I do... He's fine. You know, usually, at least the way I learned it anyway from my trainer, you do core at the end. It's like you do all your workouts, whatever your exercise is for the day, and then I finish like a cool down with a bunch of core exercises. And that's the first one I'll just ditch at the gym because I'm like, fuck it, I gotta go to work, you know, and I just leave. But it was amazing to come home, give Lindsay the car, and go, I can do core. And like, I just walked into my, you know, workout room, as I'm calling it now, and did like 15 minutes of leg raises and crunches. So I'm like, can't fucking wait to get the treadmill and the weights.
Nice. Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah, you tweeted that photo of the, I think the thing exploded view of it. Yeah, and I was like, that looks like so much fun. And I can imagine it's like, oh my God.
Yeah.
Yeah, that to me is like, that's Legos. That is adult Legos.
I was gonna be like, if you wanna come over, but it's also the same thing. Like, I put that together, I put the chair together. Crazy enough, the workout chair, it's just a chair that, you know, you can set to different heights. Probably took me 20 minutes more to put together the dip station. Like, the chair was so overly complicated, it was fucking insane. Like, that took me an hour.
Yeah.
The dip station probably took me like 80 minutes.
And so, you have the treadmill showing up tomorrow, but you have people putting that together for you.
Fuck
right?
That I'm not fucking with. Yeah, I'm not fucking with the treadmill. It's like a couple grand. I'm not gonna break it. I don't care. So it comes tomorrow, and then I have a guy coming on Sunday to put it together.
I'll tell you what the worst thing is on a treadmill. I went running this morning before I came in, and you get like this. So the gym I go to has a bunch of treadmills, you know, and there's a couple that are like the rough ones, like the bad ones that you don't know until you get on it.
Sure.
I'm a big guy. I weigh a lot, and so treadmills, like, they have to be really heavy duty for me to be able to, you know, put my foot down and you know, run on it.
Running, yeah.
And so today I warmed up, and then I started running. And I did the thing, I was about maybe a minute into it, and I put my foot down, and the treadmill slipped the other way.
Yeah. Oh,
oh my God. Yeah.
It's forward?
Yeah, like I hit and then kind of went forward about an inch and then went back.
Yeah.
It's like, oh God. And I just knew I was going to, you know, die in the middle of the gym. No. I managed to save myself and immediately stopped it.
Dude, that's brutal, because that's hit your face and slide off the treadmill. Yeah. That's just brutal and then insulting.
I have dropped my cell phone, though, because I usually, like, what?
Oh, yeah.
That happened a lot.
I don't listen to music when I run. I watch movies. Like, I have movies on my phone. Because, like, it feels like the time goes by a lot quicker.
It does.
And, but yeah, I had it one time where I went too far back and my headphones pulled my phone off and then hit and just went flying. And I was like, oh, crap. That's expensive.
For me, that works better. Like, I don't do that much running, like I said, but I will agree with you. Like, I'll watch TV more just because, like, usually the treadmills, like, I don't have the TV in it.
Yeah.
And I find myself, I'll still listen to music anyway, but more just, like, paying attention to TV because I'm just running. I'm not doing anything.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? It's just, like, TV. Music for me is fucking great for lifting weights.
Oh, yeah?
You know what I mean? Because it's like, I don't
know.
You get you pumped and you get, like, certain workout songs where it's like, I'm going to fucking put on this song now because I'm going to lift 20 pounds.
Yeah.
Now I'm going 25.
I'm Spider-Man.
Yeah, take that, Tobey Maguire.
Yeah.
But, that's you know, it's more than anything, doing cardio is just boring. Like, because, you know, I'll be on a treadmill for 45 minutes and be like, I'm going to be standing here for the next 45 minutes.
Yep. That's the thing that's, like, it's awesome about me setting up that workout room, but, like, all the equipment's super fucking expensive. And then on top of that, making it convenient is even more expensive.
Yeah, yeah.
So I already have a loose layout of how I want everything. I need to get the treadmill and have it put together and double check to make sure it all works. But ideally, I'll have the treadmill like in the corner of the room. Next to that, I'll have the pull-up bar and stuff like that. Next to that, it'll be an open space because you walk behind it to get to the pull-up bar. And then in between, or next to that open space, I'll put my weights up against the wall. And then I want to put a mirror right on that wall so you can, you know, see yourself work out with the weights and stuff like that. But already, if that all works out exactly like that, then I'm going to buy a fucking another TV and buy a wall mounting bracket and mount it to the wall right in front of the treadmill.
That's the best way
to do it. Yeah. It's like my treadmill doesn't have one. I didn't need it. But at the same time, like, I'll use it a little bit, and Lindsay will use it a bunch because she uses way more of like the treadmill and the elliptical stuff, and the bike and shit like that. And like you said, it's boring as fuck.
Yeah.
So it's like, damn it. And then I know I already have it, in my cart at Best Buy. Like, I'm just going to buy it once I get all the shit. And then I already am like, I hope these speakers are good, because if not, there's a fucking $250 soundbar I'm going to buy for the workout room. I'm still buying TVs and shit.
Yeah, like, I wish, I need to just buckle down and get the treadmill fixed. Like, the only reason I haven't done it is
so
because,
mention
like,
what you did to the treadmill.
Okay, have I talked about it on
not, I don't think on the podcast.
When I did to the treadmill, what I did to the treadmill is, you know, I used to walk and jog on it while I was watching movies and watching TV. So one day I'm like, I'm just going to turn this thing up.
And this is, you've only had it for 2-3 months. Yeah.
I'm like, but you know, I'm going to turn it up. We'll see what happens. So I started turning up the speed, and it's, I think when I hit about 8.5 or something like that, and I'm running this up, all of a sudden the engine starts making a bad noise. Like, it, like the kind of... It's not too bad, but it's
like
the kind
when
of
your
noise,
car sets on fire in GTA.
Like,
or?
Imagine the belt on the treadmill moving, and something is constantly hitting it.
Okay.
So it's like, like, you know, like hitting it, and I'm like, that's bad. So I took the thing apart and looked in, and it's coming from inside the engine.
Oof.
And I'm not taking that apart.
Right, right.
Like the motor, I'm not taking that apart. So I'm like, fuck. All right, I have a warranty on it. I gotta call somebody. Realize that the warranty sends you an email, and you go in that and sign up to make sure you have the warranty. I don't have the email anymore. I don't know what happened to it. I don't have it. So I called them because I'm like, I need another email. And as soon as I called them, they're like, all right, before we talk to you, like a machine, you need to have these numbers ready. Your account number, the serial number of the thing, what kind of model it is, blah, blah, blah. Like all this, and I just hung up. I was like, no.
Can't be bothered.
That. And I just can't be bothered to go get the numbers. And I really want to because like Daredevil is out on Netflix and I love watching that.
Yeah,
and I like, would love to walk while I watch it.
This weekend,
it's pretty
actually.
Good.
Did you watch the whole thing?
I know, I'm saying I haven't seen it yet. I'm kind of burned through it. I've seen season one. I think
I'm just up to like episode 6 or 7. But like, sitting there and watching it, I'm like, I'm a fucking idiot. I wish I had a treadmill right now. Like, I'm so mad.
I'm a fucking idiot. I like watching Daredevil, and you're like, no!
I'm so mad that I'm just sitting here and not doing anything.
That thing had to be expensive, too. I mean, that's an expensive piece of equipment.
It is very expensive. And there letting it was like a $70 warranty or something, and like, so I should really get that fixed.
Yeah, you should.
I had kind of similar to the email thing. I have an annoying thing with both, like, it happened with the treadmill and with the weights I bought. So the weights I bought, they're just dumbbells. You know, pairs that go from 5, they're in 5-pound increments, they go from 5 to 50. So it's like, it's a shitload of weight, you know, added up. And I heard that and the treadmill. And the first email I got from the treadmill was like, because I bought the service package and it was something like $80 or $100 to put the treadmill together. So I bought that. As soon as I buy it, I get an email like an hour later that basically says, oh, you're actually outside of our normal range, so it's going to cost $160 to put your treadmill together. So you need to reply to like verify that. So I just reply back, okay, and that's it. So then they reply back, all right, great, blah, 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 blah. And I guess they just like charged me the additional, you know, whatever it was. So I'm like, all right, at least that's dealt with. I need to be home and the treadmill's getting delivered. It's getting delivered tomorrow. I'll be there all day. Guy's coming on Sunday. I'm going to be there all day. Treadmill's good. With the weights, like 5 days after I order them, I get an email from them that basically says, hey, just so you know, these are like the stipulations for these weights, and we're gonna deliver them to the front of your house, but the driver will not take them off the truck and he won't put them in your house. You have to come and do that. They're like, you can unbox them on the truck if you want, so you don't have to like deal with the boxes and shit, and they're easier to carry. It's like, I have no idea how they're gonna be shipped. I don't know if it's like one weight per box, or there's like two per box or whatever. And they're like, okay, so we need you to confirm that you're gonna carry it in, that your phone number is correct, and your address is correct, because we're gonna call you and tell you when we're coming, so you can be there to carry the shit in. So, what's up?
What's up?
Yeah, what's up?
Just saying hi.
You're not saying hi, John. You've just like put yourself on the podcast. Here, everybody else comes, they get a drink, they leave. John's like, I'm in the show. You do, you know, the guy lets you on one episode of his show and he feels like you own the world. Oh, he can do that now, man.
There we go.
He offered it to him.
But anyway,
that's like the first glass of beer I've had in like years.
No, really? It's fine.
That was a sip. That wasn't a glass.
Is it gonna kill you?
We'll see.
Yeah.
So anyway,
I did put bread in
write
it.
This down on the paper and see how long it takes.
So,
some breadsticks.
Hey, thank you, Michael.
Oh, no problem. Thanks, John. Hey, thanks for the 2,000 points.
Hey.
Son of a bitch!
So, So it's scheduled to be delivered next. Don't worry about it, on the spot. I showed him my dick. Monday through Thursday of next week is when it's going to be delivered, right? So it's like, I'm waiting for them to call me.
Wait, so they give you a range? They didn't give you a specific date?
Well, no. That's just on Amazon. Like, the delivery date is Monday to Thursday. And they're telling me, we're going to call you and tell you when we're coming, but you better fucking be there and take the shit off the truck, because if you're not there and we can't get in contact with you, we're sending it back, and then you're going to have to pay for shipping if you want it back again. Wow. So I'm like, okay.
That's rough.
Yeah, so I'm waiting for this call. I don't know if it was it or not, and because the kicker there is we're going to fucking L.A. for the Doom thing on Monday, and we get back on Wednesday. So I'm more or less going to miss it Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, unless it comes on Thursday. So I'm waiting for this phone call yesterday in the middle of the fucking GTA Let's Play. I'm not going to tell you what we're doing. I'm in a cargo bob over the ocean with Jeff in a speedboat and me trying to pick him up.
Speaking of which.
And my phone rings, and I'm like, fuck, and I don't know the number, so I'm like, it might be them. I gotta answer it. And Jeremy's looking at me, and I like go away from the microphone a little bit while I'm floating in midair holding Jeff. I answer the phone, and I'm on it, and I'm like,
What's up,
dude? Oh, how are you?
Good. How you guys doing?
We're good. What's?
You're like the villain from Inspector Gadget. Like, we always say, you're on. Gotcha.
That was my funny joke.
But I mean, you know, you did Gavin.
So Jeff is hanging from underneath your chopper.
Right, so I get a phone call and I answer it, but we get horrible reception inside our office.
We're in, like, outside. Real bad.
Normally, if it was Minecraft, if it was whatever, I'll run outside for 30 seconds. I'm in a fucking helicopter holding his boat. And I was like,
and Jeff's in the
hello?
Boat.
And I'm like, hello? 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 And then the call drops because it sucks. No. And I'm like, fuck! And now I'm like looking at my phone going, if they call again, I have to run outside. Like, I have to run outside. They never called back. So it's like, I don't know if it had nothing to do with anything, or it was like a robot calling me to tell me when the delivery was, but since I picked it up, it's like, they got the call, and then it didn't leave a voicemail. So now I still have no idea when they're coming.
Did you Google the phone number?
I didn't do that. I should do that. Because, and then the kicker there is, my contact number, if I'm not there, is my phone number. I know they're going to call me while I'm flying to Los Angeles.
Yeah.
I'm going to be in the air, and they're like, fuck this dude, you're not getting your weights.
It's gonna be Tuesday during the stream, and you're going to be
I got to take this.
Hey, Gronk. Like, Gronk, take this for me.
Gronk, defend. It'd be like Mario Kart Double Dash.
I'll just switch to the back
and get my phone.
Hey, Jeff.
Hey. Well, how was your meeting?
Welcome to Off Topic.
Woo! It was good.
Was it meaty?
Was it? Meaty, a lot of talking.
Did you meet with Matt Hullum?
I met with a Hullum.
Oh,
tell him to rap. I need him to rap.
Oh, that's true.
Oh, you told me before I went
that one out. You should mention that. That's out.
What's out?
The rap.
Yeah, Ryan versus
Gus. What's
that?
That thing you spent months on.
The fuck are you talking
Ryan
about?
Ryan versus Gus is out. And I want to bring up that every single time I do these videos, I spell one word incorrectly in the video.
Was it Ryan?
I caught this one.
Every time. In this one, it was the word jesters, like clowns, you know?
Right.
You know, J-E-S-T-E-R-S. I wrote it gestures, like you gesture, like, but with a J.
Yeah, misspelled gesture.
I know how to spell it, but I didn't see it as I was going through. Like, I sit there and I watch all the lines. I'm like, that's right. Sometimes you're just blind to it. Like, if you go over it, you're like, sure, that's right. And I was, fuck! And I noticed it this time. But Ryan and Gus did a really good job.
They did.
In it. I had to do a lot of cutting and moving things very slightly to get them on beat, because sometimes they kind of fell
off. They did very good.
There.
Off beat and off key, apparently.
There isn't really a key for rap.
Should that be an album of this, it should be off beat and off key.
Yeah. Well, I thought, like, in the beginning, did you say Ryan was rapping like this? That is
He was auto-tuned, actually.
Ryan always had that, like, Mad King voice he does for X-Ray and Bad.
Oh, where he takes like 8 times longer to say a sentence.
Yes, exactly. So he's trying to say things
shorter. Ah, welcome to my lair.
Like, exactly. So he was trying to do that, and like, it was just getting like slower and slower, a little more upbeat. I was like, I get you're the Mad King, but just rap. And like, at one point, Meg showed up. And was sitting. Oh,
did that inspire him?
She turned and went.
She was sitting in the recording. she came in and sat at the recording booth and was watching Ryan like rap. And he did one line, fucked it up, did it again. I was like laughing a little bit, and he's like, "Stop laughing! I'm trying." And so, like, and then he like fucked it up again, and Meg's like, he's not going to be done the next, like, half hour, is he? I was like, no.
Oh, right, because she, like, wanted to snatch him.
Yeah, exactly. Like, she's like, all right, cool, I'll get someone else. Yeah. And they walked out, because, like, it was one line we just kept doing, and he's like,
what was the line? Was it the alliteration line?
It was the
line?
No, the alliteration, right? I mean, obviously that one took forever. It was one that I, like, didn't expect to take forever. I
really?
I totally don't remember what
did
line
he kept
it was,
saying but... Apex?
He did not.
Is that what it was?
I should have put that, I should have just made a line that was all the word Apex.
And yeah.
Apex, 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 Apex. And then that was it.
So you're working on the what, Bernie Mountain, the
he's
Church
working
and Sarge?
Trying to wrangle him.
Church yeah. and Sarge.
That's
which,
next.
I actually changed up a little bit, because in the original one I made, it was Church and Sarge, and then Tucker and Simmons jumped in.
Okay.
For like a verse.
But is that you call?
No.
But instead, for this one, we're making Felix and Locust jump in.
Okay.
So we have Miles and Gray, who's going to rap as well.
Nice.
So getting Bernie and Matt into the booth is a whole ordeal.
I want to be there when you get Joel versus Joel.
Joel versus Caboose. Yes, that's the rap after this one.
You probably don't even have to edit anything.
He does not... He definitely does not remember that he said yes to this.
You know how...
He will not do it.
You know how... You know how Nelly had the Saint Lunatics?
Yeah.
And 50 Cent has G-Unit?
Mm-hmm.
This is like Macklemore's less talented group of white friends.
It really is.
Like his college roommates.
Yeah.
He's
yeah.
like, hey guys, I also rap. Rap, rap, rap.
Can we do like Lil J, Blood on the Sands? Make that a game?
God.
It's a great game.
I'm excited
it's
for it.
It's a fantastic game.
Yeah, I'm excited. I love watching those things, and I don't know if I'm looking forward to the rapping part, but it's going to be fun.
It'll be swell.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they're a lot of fun, but you have to write them very... Like, comedy raps on YouTube are written very differently than, like, rap music when you hear it. Like, it has
really?
To be, like, it has to be, like, simple and, like...
Nice.
Hey, thanks.
Wow.
Hey,
we need you to rap. That's
a lot.
We need what right now.
Yeah. Right now.
That's he's not that hard to get a hold of. He's right
yeah,
there.
Yeah,
right. What the hell are you talking about?
Have you a lot more beer.
Have you ever did you email him yet?
This
I
is
did.
Your moment.
I did do that.
Don't miss your chance.
One
I'm
shot.
Miss my
one
chance.
Shot.
I'm terrified.
One opportunity.
Terrified.
And there it goes.
Yep. Peace
and
out.
No, I'm
sorry. I love you, Bernie.
You know what, though? Grab that. If we can isolate that piece out, you can use that for
there
the
There you
rap.
Go.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
If you write that
thing.
Line in.
That would be perfect.
Man, shout out to Broadcast, by the way, for refilling the beer with a new keg.
Oh, yeah,
ran
awesome.
Out last week.
Did
on
they
the...
get new liquor?
They did, actually. Yes.
Yeah?
They did, because I noticed that.
There's
that Tito's
tequila.
Is new. That stuff over there is new. There's all kinds of new
is
stuff.
Is that, like, I thought it was just... Is that moonshine?
Are you upset because they did?
Nah, because I was like, I was.
Oh, yeah, like,
moonshine.
Moonshine.
Because
moonshine. You thought there was no liquor, though. And now you're like,
I didn't know there was going to be a like fucking Disney World behind me.
Oh, there it is.
Hey, Disney World, bring it back.
Woohoo!
You want some El Dorado rum?
No, God, no. No rum for me.
What do we got? We got.
I'm not.
We got Patron, we got moonshine.
Buffalo Trace Kentucky Whiskey? Come on, yeah, you love whiskey.
Michael, I gotta be honest with you, I'm not much of a drinker.
No, are you sure? Just waiting for you to open it.
Is this a short glass?
This is ruining my 2-day streak.
Sorry about that. No, the glass fell in front of you, too.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Is that a shot glass?
I don't know, but it has thumbtacks.
It's a shot glass. Don't drink that.
You probably shouldn't drink out of that, then.
I'm gonna.
Although alcohol
I'm gonna legitimately
yeah,
take this as a bonus for 2016 from Bernie.
You worked hard.
So.
Yeah, that's your congratulations.
Yeah, I think I do. I'm glad you agree. What, you're not gonna drink out of the toilet? Like a real achievement hunter?
Yeah.
It's like a little hat. Oh, dude, speaking of which, like the real achievement hunter thing, did you see I Am Achievement Hunter? Did you see that?
No,
yeah,
no.
So somebody,
you are the achievement hunter.
But the Doom thing, you know, there was a couple articles about it. Like a couple people posted, you know, like super famous athletes playing with loser YouTubers.
Yeah, yeah. With who?
And, yeah, exactly. Like Ocho Cinco and huh?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'll just do this.
But somebody tweeted me a picture of their local newspaper. I can't remember where it was. And they were like, oh, you know, they mentioned you in the newspaper. And it's like, oh, cool. And it was really cool because they took like a sideways picture and then didn't bother to turn it right.
Yeah, yeah.
So you have to look at your phone like that or else it'll just turn and be wrong. But I was reading it and it literally says, it's like, you know, Justine and then her last name, which I don't know off the top of my head. And then like parentheses, like I Justine, like who's who.
Wait for a good moment.
And it says, it gets to me and it said something like,
is that a hair?
Michael Jones. YouTube handle known as Achievement Hunter. And I was like, it's me!
You are Achievement Hunter.
I am Achievement Hunter.
Son of a bitch!
No, there you go.
Known by his YouTube handle, Achievement Hunter.
Known by his YouTube handle, Achievement Hunter, Michael Jones reps Team Gronk. Nice, that's me. Welcome, guys. Yeah. Thanks for joining me.
Yeah.
I knew this would work out.
Oh, okay. There is liquor in there.
Also, I think a hair.
Yeah, there's dirt.
Was there a hair before or after?
Before.
Why didn't you pull it out?
Is that a toilet? You know what that means? That is a pube.
That's a pube.
Hair. Yeah.
Oh.
That's a pube.
Do it.
What have you
talked about yet today? Have you talked about the race to a million?
Sure did.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. Gavin came on as we're all sitting here doing the podcast, and I go, so Gavin, like, what's it at? And he says, "Oh, is it over? Did you check?" I'm like, "Well, I thought you would."
Ask you?
And he goes, "Oh, I was at lunch." That's how committed Gavin is.
Can we make his video private for a couple days?
That'd be awesome.
So,
I don't know if I can see like live updates on my phone. I think they're slower than.
Yeah.
Are they?
Did y'all talk about?
Worried.
We haven't talked about theater mode yet.
Theater mode.
Yeah. Mentioned it's a thing. I said coming soon.
Yeah.
Do you want to add to that?
We should give props to the person who came up with the idea. Is it Kittens Are Evil?
He suggested the name.
Thank you very much. Nice. That is very, very awesome.
Well done.
And a very off-topic-like move.
Yeah. Kittens Are Evil. Message me on Reddit, and I'll get your information, and we'll send you some stuff. So thank
that
you.
That I didn't give anything to the guy that came up with off-topic,
really?
I get Jack would have given you something. That makes you feel better.
Not prepared to give a release date just yet.
Right.
I'll be honest with you.
That's why I said
I know what the release date is, but
I knew what it was before the one you recorded today.
Yeah.
I don't know if that pushed it back.
So today was the third one we filmed.
This is the day. Oh, it might not be.
It was the third one we filmed.
Today's episode was rough. The movie was rough.
It's okay. We're gonna speak very generically. This is a 5-episode series. It's like a pilot
for now.
Episodes. If it goes well and people like it, we will continue to do it ad nauseum, right? See if you can pick out
throw up?
Which of the 5 was today's episode when you watch them, assuming you watch them down the road. Not you, but you the audience.
I got there.
They may
like,
not be
sucks.
In order.
Like, they will be in order of film.
Well, I think the first one will be the first one.
First
one's
first one.
Should we say what the title is just to give people a little tease, a little hint?
Theater mode.
There you go. I mean, I think here's 5 movies. Well, I want it to be like a surprise.
Then don't say it.
Right. Yeah, leave it.
Well, I mean, they're going to see it in the title of the episode.
No, the first movie's a great one.
We
do filmed, not spoil
I think
it.
We filmed, thus far, we filmed an A+, an A, and another episode.
We filmed today's episode.
That first movie, I saw the first movie that you guys watched.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
so you can go back through off topic and look, it's one of the 4 movies he's seen.
It was it was actually Men in
you
Black.
You will never guess this one.
Here's, I'll help you too. It's not Face Off. So that takes 1 hour. Yeah.
I've seen that so much.
And that's 80% of the movies
you've seen.
Yeah,
it's Grandma's Boy.
Nicolas Cage doesn't have a face. He's like, take a fucking
Grandma's. Yes. It's not Grandma's Boy, but Grandma's Boy is one of the episodes we tested.
Yeah.
We tested sort of.
Yeah, so
about 40 minutes of it.
Yeah, not even that.
Two things. One, we didn't have time that day. Two, really good movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we were going to do, I'll talk about the process though. We were going to do 4 test episodes.
Jeff, you know, if
that's beautiful. I will. So we're going to do 4 test episodes. Right?
Yeah.
Then we figured that would be enough. That'd be enough practice to be ready to go out the gate.
Yeah.
After we filmed the 4th test episode, we said, we need to film 4 more test episodes.
It's different because...
Let's playing and Mystery Science Theatering are 2 very different skills.
Yeah, because there's like this fine line of like, you know, talking over the movie, but also letting the movie kind of, you know, talk because you want to be able to follow the plot. Like, we don't want to talk constantly over a film, and so...
And we're very used to like, if there's silence, that's a bad thing.
Exactly. Like, dead air is like the worst thing
on
the planet.
You can cut dead air out of a video game in a Let's Play.
Right.
You can't cut seconds out of a movie. I mean... A lot of movies, maybe you should cut.
Yeah.
I don't
think you cut 20 minutes out of the movie.
Yeah, no one bothered to edit these things.
Yeah.
But.
So it makes it a little bit more difficult. I also have been. Part of the process was figuring out the best way to create the product. Like, we tested it a bunch of different ways. We tested where 3 people went into it, we tested it with 4 people, too many. Too much talking. It just became a podcast.
Yeah.
So we whittled it down to 3. Then we tested it with 3 people having never seen the movie. A little difficult.
Yeah.
We tested it with 3 people having seen the movie. People talk over each other. Everybody writes a joke in their head for this moment.
Everyone
knows. You got 3 people trying to talk at the same time. So what we settled on the format is 1 person watches the movie ahead of time, and then the other 2 have never seen it. And they go, and that 1 person can kind of steer.
Yeah.
Right.
They might know the title of it, but other than that, they
they know
seen
the title, but nothing else.
Yeah.
And so that format has worked out really well for us. I don't want to give away all of our trade secrets so you can. Make your own.
Yeah,
make
your own. Yeah.
But it's, that's the way it works, is one person, so far it's been me every time, has seen the movie going into it, and then the other two people riff. And I write jokes at home at night. Another interesting thing that I've discovered is difficult, not writing joke part. That part's actually surprisingly easy, until this week. I would watch a movie and write like 70 jokes.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
You can't put them on your hand.
Yeah.
So like before an episode of Theater Mode, I'll sit at this table, because this is all set up because we filmed it right before this, and I just like look over my notes and go like memorize, and then you sit down and it goes.
It's all goes
away. How do you think I feel, Jeff? I come up with a new website to write, and I'm like, whoa, like, I gotta remember that one.
It's absolutely, it's been an interesting process. Yeah. Last night I sat and I watched this movie, came up with 8 jokes.
Yeah.
Don't think I used any of them. I was like, this one's gonna be tough. I still think it went pretty well.
I think
it went
all right.
In the grand scheme of things,
there were 3 or 4 times that were pretty funny.
In
but,
the grand, what the fuck are you doing? In the grand scheme of things, I think it went pretty well.
Yeah. But yeah, I think the first couple movies
it
were
was
pretty
not
good.
easy as the other two. I like it. I tell you what, it's challenging in a really fun way, and I think it. Stretches our comedic muscles.
Yeah, yeah. It's a different sort of style of humor that works with these, as opposed to kind of just, you know, yelling at each other.
I'll tell you who else easily superstar of the show so far.
Huh?
Jack Patillo.
Oh, yes.
Nice.
Absolutely
the sweetheart.
Absolutely the best person so far.
You're a sweetheart.
Weakest of the bunch? Jeff Ramsey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's crazy because
can't yell over a movie.
Listen.
Yeah.
You just gotta steer it, you know? You can't power it as well. You just gotta let it go
different.
Where it's going.
As somebody who's watched almost every episode
just
of Mr. Science Theater and thought I would be great at that,
ooh,
you
didn't have as much Coke as you thought in there, did you?
I will say,
okay, that's about half Coke and half whiskey. That's
while it's very different than what we normally do, and that was the biggest struggle in the beginning, was like not treating it like a Let's Play, because it's not. I will say, at the same time, modifying that, I think, was a lot easier than learning how to do it. I appreciate the fact that we sit down and we're ready to watch a 90-minute movie.
Yeah.
It's like we're used to sitting down and playing a fucking video game and talking for 60, 70, 80 minutes sometimes. So it's different, but at least we have, like, the mental fortitude to just get through fucking shit.
We have developed... I don't want to sound egotistical.
Do it.
But I think
we were all
years,
talking. I mean, we talked about the Million View video.
We've developed.
Right, yeah, I mean,
we've developed.
I fucking jerk myself off looking at
We've developed a callus to that, or like a stamina that I notice when other people come in. They
right, a lot of
think
guests.
It's normal.
A lot of guests like, are
we
like.
We can literally go in and film 10 45-minute Let's Plays in a day, talk for 7 hours straight with 5-minute potty breaks and whatnot.
Yeah, yeah.
Right,
and feel okay. We did. Some Let's Plays recently with some people that came in to visit in the last, like, I guess sometime in the last 6 months.
Right.
And I went out to dinner with those people, great people, and they were like, I'm exhausted. And I was like, from what? And they're like, those 2 Let's Plays we did with you guys. And I was like, that was like 1 hour and 10 minutes.
Yeah, that was,
and they're like,
that was lunch.
You guys, how many times a week do you guys do that? And I was like, today was a real light day.
We
do that times 3, 5 days a week.
Yeah, I mean, we had like Dante come in and awesome.
Dante Bosco.
That was awesome.
Awesome. Really
cool.
And we recorded 2 Let's Plays with him. One's come out with the Star Wars Let's Play came out, and the other one hasn't yet.
No.
And
we got a lot of not to interrupt you, but we've been doing a ton of collaborations. I would say we're sitting on 20 Let's Plays that have people from outside of Achievement Hunter participating.
Yeah, yeah.
Whether it's like Funhouse and Screw Attack or other people.
Yeah, we had Neck Deep. We had the band Neck Deep come by for one Let's Play. That turned out great.
There's a lot of that.
A lot of that level stuff that we're sitting on.
And that's fun.
So it's
like,
kind of hard to peter like
meter
when it comes out.
We spent, you know, kind of years sort of being like isolated from the rest of kind of the gaming community.
Some would say hating. Not even gaming. I mean, it's like
just everyone.
Yeah, but now we very much embrace it, and like we're bringing people in, and like we have a good setup now where it's a lot easier to bring people into.
Yeah,
I think. So I think that's helped.
It's true.
But yeah, like with Dante, like we filmed 2 things with him, and we're like, hey, want to do another? And he was like, oh man, I gotta go. I mean, he had other stuff to do, but you could tell he was like, all right, you know, it's kind of tapped
out.
We
filmed, I don't think it's much of a spoiler, the first game we filmed.
We
played Smite with him.
Yeah, we played some Smite.
Right, because he's a big League of Legends.
Yeah,
League of Legends.
Yeah, he walks in, he's like, I play League, you guys play League? He's like,
no.
No. We play Smite, it's close.
That was a very, you know, talkative Let's Play. There was like strategy, we asked him some stuff here and there. I mean, it wasn't super interviewee, but we got into a little bit and we talked about it. This and that was a great video. And then we film Starwall, and it's just 30 minutes of screaming. Oh, yeah. That's it. It's just him going,
can't get out of this lava. I was watching that video, and to hear fucking, like, Prince Zuko and her say, fuck you, Jeremy! I was like, yes!
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
Is that your ringtone now?
Yeah.
It's like every text message he gets.
Perfect. But yeah, so Theater Mode has been a lot of fun. It's been really interesting because it's a complimentary product, but a lot harder. Maybe not harder, just different.
Different.
Yeah, it's very different from the stuff we normally do.
We're pretty amazing, so it's like, we'll adapt. You know?
It took a lot more preparation than I thought it would.
I will say, I'm really curious to see the audience reaction to it.
Oh, they'll hate it.
I mean,
I really hope they like it.
Yeah, Did you guys see how that logo went over?
We talked about the logo, too.
I really hope they like it. Because I really, really, really like doing it.
It's fun.
Yeah, yeah.
And it is fun in a way that I haven't had fun.
Yeah, and it opens up opportunities. Like, we could do stuff. Like, we could do a live one, too. Like, that would be so much fun to do, and I think an audience would love that
kind of
stuff.
I could see that in our future if the show continues.
Yeah, and so I hope it goes over well, because I really enjoy doing this. I mean, like, I love movies, and so, like, getting a chance to actually, you know, make fun of movies live is a lot of fun.
I also say, well, I've said this before, but I want to reiterate so people understand, because there seems to be some confusion about it. Stop sending us submissions for movies, maybe, that had $200 million budgets. We're actually paying for the licensing of the movies.
Yeah.
Like, I spent from September or October until January of this year dealing with different movie production companies, licensing these films and paying for them and getting the legal rights to do this. So, this is 100% on the up and up legit.
Yeah.
Which is part of why it's behind.
Yeah, because rebroadcasting something, that's why you see in front of movies.
I mean,
like,
that's it. Like, you see the whole fucking movie. I mean, it's just, it's us watching the movie. You don't have to, like, watch the movie along with it. My phone's ringing. Do you think it's them?
Oh, is it them?
Do you think it's them? I gotta go. I don't know.
This could be it.
It's, I've seen discussions on it. People have been like, aren't they just ripping off the movie companies? I mean, maybe in a certain way.
But you're paying for it.
We're paying for the right to rip off these movie companies. But
pay for the right to rip on them.
Yeah, and also the people like, oh, I hope they do, you know, movie X that I've seen 1,000 times. Like, no, we're not going to. Yeah, we're not going to do Office Space. We're not going to do Howard the Duck. We're going
to
do movies that
you've never
heard of.
I mean, if we
can
get the rights to it, but we probably can't afford the rights to those movies.
Yeah, I don't think
we're doing movies we can afford the rights to.
So no,
which, luckily enough, are the kind of movies you would want to do this with.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
You're Plan 9 from outer space.
Yeah, and to be fair, it's like...
Manos Hands of Fate style.
Yeah, it's a lot easier to do it, like, movies that aren't, you know, particularly well-made or well-acted. It's a lot easier to have fun with those than something that's like, this is a well-produced movie.
Right, like, which was something we discovered in the test, because in the testing, which will never come out, so we don't have to worry about it.
Yeah.
But in the test, we did a lot of different movies, and one of the problems was, it'd be like, here's your movie today, it's Weird Science.
It's
Jack and I have both seen that movie 20 times. Plus, it's like, Weird Science is a good movie. And then it's just us going like...
Is that them, Michael?
Bullshit, it was just the treadmill. I already know what's coming tomorrow between 6 a.m. and 9 a.m. Damn it!
Oh, this is my favorite part of the movie.
Yeah,
this is why it does this.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like, oh, so here's Robert Downey Jr. Oh, he was just Robert Downey at the time. Like... Yeah, we've seen those movies. So it's like, now we're getting into stuff where it's like, I sit down and I'm sitting and watching a movie I've never seen before in my life. And that's it's been fun. And so,
it's
fun.
It's also cool because you can kind of find, like, diamonds in the rough, sort of. Like,
no, you don't. Well, I mean, there's no diamonds.
I said you could. I didn't say you're going to find them every day.
You find diamond turds in the rough.
You find a lot of
it's like finding corn and shit.
Another part of this. There you go.
I am back.
You find a lot of tits and dead bodies.
Yeah, I was going to say, I had to license these through trailers. Like, the production companies would give me trailers.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Be like, you get like a 3-minute window in a movie, and you think, like, all right, well, that'll work. If this show continues, round two, I will approach that process differently.
You'll watch the movie first.
I did not anticipate the amount of nudity that is in these movies.
Yeah.
We watched a movie.
It's fine.
There's been a lot of tits.
Straight up vagina, like, three times.
Damn,
like,
dude, I missed that one. Come on.
I can see where the baby comes from.
Yeah.
What do we do about it? I don't know if we're going to blur it or if we're going to
put a baby over it.
I think we're going
to
put Gavin's face over it.
Gavin's face up? I don't know.
I like the
point where I'm a little uncomfortable sitting on a sofa with like Ryan and Jack.
It's just a raging boner.
Especially like Ryan's getting
and it's
really
like,
into it.
Am I watching Insertion? You know? Like, ugh.
We had a rough one in what's going to be, I guess, episode one.
Oh, yeah. The literally the first scene of...
That's not what I'm talking about.
Oh, I'm talking about that.
I'm talking about something rough later, but there was no nudity in it. It was just like, I can't believe this is happening. I don't know what
I know exactly the scene you're talking about.
I think I know what he's talking about.
But it's not great.
Yeah.
You'll figure it out. I'll tell you.
Yeah.
I want to say the one-liner from that scene.
It's okay. Don't say it. You'll give it away.
Yeah.
Anyway, theater mode.
Oh!
Coming soon. There we go.
Got it. Got it. I was thinking about the wrong movie. Yeah. No, that was rough. That was a lot of, like, I feel like a bad person for watching it.
We had, damn it, I don't want to spoil it.
Right. Yeah. Keep it vague.
We may have initiated some sort of drinking game. I drank at that point, even though I wasn't supposed to. Because I just wanted another one.
Yeah, it deserved
that's
it.
What I'm talking about.
You wanted to bleach your brain.
I wanted to not be where I was at the moment in that movie.
Yeah, we can tell
we're selling this.
We can say the drinking game rules, right? Like, that's okay. That doesn't spoil anything.
We
have like four rules right now, where it's if you take a shot if you see boobs, vagina.
Well, no, you see nipple.
Nipple, okay, excuse me.
Right.
Yeah, nipple, and then vagina, penis, or balls.
Yeah.
Butts, you do a sip for a butt. This is nude, by the way. This isn't like clothed. And then anytime someone breaks the fourth wall, like looks into the camera, you do a shot as well.
That's what we've established so far.
Which is also very tricky, though, because in the quality of these films, people stare right into the camera a lot.
Sometimes you might get one of these. Like, breaking the fourth wall
but
is
this isn't breaking
like,
the fourth wall.
A character goes like...
Right.
That's breaking the fourth wall, and you hold it. A lot of times you see this. That's not intentionally breaking the fourth wall.
That's just poor acting.
Where am I looking? Where else do I look?
Poor
where
spatial.
Else do I look? I'm looking right at it! I'm looking at it!
I'm so confused!
I definitely did that just in that little thing we filmed for Minecraft 200, where we were live action.
Oh, has that come out yet?
Yeah, that's
coming out. Well, it's Friday, so...
No, it's out for public.
No, it should be public,
right? Oh, you're right. We thought that about the other one, so let me see.
Don't you worry, it's public.
It is out. It should be. It is out.
Alright.
Yeah.
I'll double check.
But,
Jeremy, he was just,
good.
Like, fighting his dad. In
we're good.
The
we're good.
Intro.
Right.
How are people liking Minecraft 200?
Let's see.
I thought our little live action intro
oh my
was
God, you're,
great.
I lost it several times in that video just from your clues. Your clues are like the funniest things to me.
Oh, really?
In Minecraft 200. Yeah.
Oh, thanks.
The little rhymes.
Gavin had some good ones, too.
Yeah, he had some good ones,
the
too.
Wheaties
yeah.
one is my favorite thing.
Easily my favorite one was the Wheaties one. Like, it was just the Wheaties was what got me.
I wish I would have had more time to put into those. Because those are like, I don't know, those are just so much fun to write.
Yeah.
That's one, I guess, downside of what we do at Achievement Hunter and Let's Play is that everything is off the cuff and like in-the-moment comedy. You don't ever get the opportunity to write stuff, and I really love writing. I used to want to be a writer. This was way easier, though, so it's depressing. Yeah. But like, I had to write all those in like 10 minutes. I was like on a plane headed to... somewhere. And I was like, oh shit, these are due. I gotta write these right now. And I just wrote, it was like first draft, all of them. And then I sent them in and I felt bad, but I'm glad you guys liked them.
Okay. Yeah,
that
was some
funny. If I gotta put another day into those, I think I did.
Do you wanna write the podcast from now on? Because we lost the script.
Yeah.
The misplaced script.
We talked about that earlier.
Oh shit.
Screw the off topic script. Gone.
Man, we're really just going off what you're saying here right now.
I wish I had time.
Yeah.
Time has become a commodity that I don't have a lot of.
Yeah, I know.
This sucks. Like, I wanted to be on the podcast today,
yeah.
But I missed the first hour and 15 minutes because I had a meeting. And I really, to be totally honest with you, shouldn't be here right now because I have things I have to do because of that meeting.
Oh.
That I'm ignoring.
Nah, you're not doing your job.
I also am 41 minutes late for another meeting.
Yeah, see, I thought you had a meeting at 1.
I decided not to go to and didn't tell anybody.
They figured it out. Yeah. You're not there.
2016, Jeff, is way too
about
busy.
About 35 minutes in, they're like, he's probably not coming.
Yeah.
Well, then they watch this, and it's like, yeah, he's definitely not.
They might be on to you at this point. Are they? Do you know? Are they sponsors though?
Oh, speaking of which,
can they see it?
Patrick in broadcasting, I have to have a meeting with you.
Do you want to do it now?
Should
we leave, or do you want to take the table?
I forgot my laptop today, so there's my laptop.
Two post-it notes.
Action items we need to talk about.
Is Guinness
written
on
there? I'm so glad you said that. It totally blows my mind. I was fucking watching TV last night, and only because of you. I never thought anything of it. Whatever. Flipping to the channels, you know, lived in my house for almost a year. Still haven't really gotten that much into TV, what channels there are. They're new channels.
Yeah.
I find a channel called Vice, Action Bronson TV show.
Vice? Fuck, that's delicious.
Fuck, that's delicious. I'm flipping through the channels. I'm just like, oh, fuck, that's Action Bronson. I watched like 3 episodes in a row.
Which episodes did you watch?
He was eating a bunch of Indian shit, as he kept calling it. He's like, it was great. He's like, I fucking love this shit. It was one where he was going on about how he hates breakfast and he'd never eat breakfast food and he'd rather just eat this shit and that shit and this shit every single day. And he was there with a black dude and he's like, fuck, this is good. This is fucking good. And the two of them are just like big. The black dude wasn't that fat. Action Bronson's fucking fat. And he's just like, so it might have
been
delicious.
It might have been Mayhem Loren. He raps with him a lot.
It could have been it. And then one of them was new, just because I checked the info and it said new.
I'm pretty far behind. I'm probably a season or I don't know how.
It was entertaining.
I'm probably 8 to 10 episodes behind. I just don't have time. I still haven't finished Jessica Jones yet.
Oh, yeah. I haven't started Jessica Jones.
Two episodes.
Yeah, is there any fucking crossover with Daredevil? Like, yes. You have to watch Jessica Jones before season two?
No, you don't have to.
That's what I meant.
I mean, you'll see stuff.
There's
like,
crossover character.
Yeah.
There's a crossover
damn
character
it. That means
in Jessica Jones.
I can't watch Daredevil until I fucking
watch that. I don't know.
Is it season 2 Daredevil, though?
How far are you in?
Season 1 Daredevil.
Okay.
How far are you in Daredevil season 2?
I've watched the first 4 episodes.
Oh, so you haven't watched any more since then?
I've watched the Punisher arc.
Right, that is the point. I mean, he's not done yet.
No, I assume he's not, but I've watched that arc.
I can still hear you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like the end of episode 4 sets up the next arc. I won't say who the character is.
Right.
Yeah.
Starts with
if you've watched the trailer, you know.
Yeah. Starts with an E.
Yeah.
It's fucking fantastic, though.
And then they got the Luke Cage ones coming out too, right?
Oh, yeah.
That's very awesome.
Oh, he's in Jessica Jones, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah.
Luke Cage is in Jessica Jones, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, but then he has his own series.
He's
too.
A big part of
a being
portion
insider?
Of.
Oh.
He's a apparently it's a real big part.
Yeah.
Of season of being in a portion of that show.
And I mean, the point of all of this, obviously, is seriously buy a Southeast Pemberton shirt.
I like where you're going. You should really go with Northern North Havermeyer.
Listen, I am seriously outnumbered.
But, why didn't you
all members of Northern North Havermeyer?
The entire league is here right now.
This one, but really, he just hates his league, which is why he didn't wear it. He couldn't rep it. The whole podcast.
All of week one is out.
Yes.
And it's a 6-week season.
Oh, dude, and like you showed up now all 4 Northern North Havermeyer.
Yeah, Northern
Havermeyer. Oh yeah.
And then one filthy Pemberton.
Listen, if you gotta decide, which shirt to buy, unless you're a pacifist and buy both.
What would a pacifist buy both?
Because they don't want anyone.
They don't
want to
fight. No conflict.
Yeah. We talked about week one.
There's conflict in the leagues, though.
Listen, if you are a psychopath, unpredictable fuck, buy Southeast Pemberton. That represents us.
I want to tell a story.
I will say though, no, I'm just saying that I don't.
I'm very red because I've had a lot.
Yesterday's isn't out yet for the public. So Northern Nor North.
No,
we haven't talked.
I'm not gonna say.
About
I don't even remember who's
it
in.
It is out for the public.
Guys.
But
they might not have watched it. Just out 2 seconds.
I want to tell a story.
I want to talk about.
Keep in mind, the only people hearing this now are. Listen.
I know, Jeremy, but they might not have watched it yet. Give them a few.
If you're paying for the sponsorship, watch the ice hockey.
Give them a few days, man. Come on.
Matter
what you think, The Rock is cooking.
That's what he says.
Somebody get this kid an Uber home after the podcast.
Fall. It doesn't matter what you think, The Rock is cooking, son.
Here's a little story I want to tell. I had this idea. I've had this idea to do a sports league for a very, very, very long time. We did it internally at RT back in 2005.
Nice,
we played baseball. It was just me and Matt and Bernie and Gus and Joel, maybe, or Ryan. Not Ryan, he wasn't around. Nathan and Jason. And it fell apart because Matt Hullum wouldn't play his games. The rest of us were like, please play your game. And he was always like, family. So it was like maybe 2005, 2006. But I wanted to redo it since then, and I wanted to do it as an Achievement Hunter property since then. But Jack likes football. But the rest of you motherfuckers can't stand. I was going to say college football, but I think he just likes football.
Like football.
He likes to think he likes football.
Jesus. Damn.
I don't even know what that means, but okay.
Don't worry about it, Jack.
You don't know what football is.
The rest of you guys hate sports. I love sports.
I don't hate sports.
Shut the fuck up, you hate it.
I tolerate that they exist.
I know you
don't. Good call. I hate it.
So, I've been wanting to do this for a long time, but I thought, like, they're never going to want to do it. They're not going to get into it. And then I was like, the hockey stuff went so well.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Those two Let's Plays. I thought, we're going to do a league. I want to do a hockey league. But then I thought, what's the buy-in going to be for the audience? We should let them vote on the sport. I pray that they vote for the right sport. They did. They voted for hockey. Took fucking
best
forever
choice
to film. But when I told you guys, I was like, here's what we're going to do. Here's my idea. We're going to do a hockey league. Everybody, Jack's like, yeah, whatever. Everybody else was like, eh. Michael was like, oh, why?
Probably.
And I looked at him and I thought, just wait.
Yeah.
Just wait.
And now
guy.
We're all
just
so wait. Invested in
and
it.
And now, and then I watched it. The second it hit go and Michael had the control, he was like, this is the most important thing in the world.
Also,
I knew it was going to happen. He's the most competitive person.
Some of the episodes are filmed out of order in the sense of, like I said, so Tuesday, Wednesday for YouTube release is like Pemberton and then Northern Nor North. But depending on who's in the office, sometimes we had to film like one Pemberton, one Nor North. So it's like we had to keep track of what was next and where it was going. So my first match that I play was like, I think the fourth match that we filmed. So it's like, I watched three matches.
Well,
so
that was it. I was gonna say, Michael.
I got it and was like, Gideon, I'm playing this.
Michael literally, he was watching the three matches. I remember this because I was just sitting in my chair watching the whole thing happen. Michael stands up because Jeff left to go get Matt because that's the first person Michael was playing. And so Jeff leaves to go get him. Michael is pacing back and forth from his desk to the couch. And he's going, I'm going to crush him. I'm going to crush Matt. Bring it on.
Sometimes
I want to hurt him.
Dude, Ryan and I are undefeated in NHL, okay? In those
sometimes the most fun you can have in Achievement Hunter is watching Michael watch other stuff.
Oh, yeah.
It really is. I don't think he knows how much he's, people are just like.
What?
Nothing. Nothing.
Because you're so entertaining.
Yeah. Why?
I knew this thing would be a home run because I knew everybody would buy in.
I knew.
I love how much Lindsay bought into it from the
get-go. Oh, yeah.
Super competitive.
Yeah, Michael and Lindsay have both been practicing too. Oh, my and God. Jeremy, dude. Too.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I haven't played any game outside of the game.
I haven't either.
Recorded. But yeah, like those guys are getting into it.
And,
like,
Lindsay, Michael, and I all played.
Yeah,
all played.
I got so mad because I bought a Red Wings shirt. And I was gonna like fucking the first match. I was gonna like yeah, and, like reveal that I had the shirt on the whole time, and then we didn't film live action.
I actually went in to get Matt for the first match after Michael was doing the pacing thing, and Matt's like, oh okay, I'm up. All right, good. And he takes out the jersey in the plastic bag, still brand new, like he just got it shipped. And I was like, you know, we're not doing live action. He goes, well, that sort of ruined the whole thing.
That
sucks.
That is fucking funny.
It's been fucking awesome though, and it was one of those things where we started, and it's a 6 week show.
Yeah,
well, it's actually
it's an
8 week.
Yeah,
but the regular season is 6 weeks, and we filmed all 6 weeks in.
Yeah, we talked about how we're so excited that we had
a couple, like a week or two.
Yeah, it took
we had
like
to wait.
2 months
but only,
to start.
Only
though,
because
it?
Only, but like yeah,
the
like
the only
like,
reason we ever stopped is because people weren't.
You by 4 days, it was like 2 weeks, but it was like four recordings.
Yeah,
yeah, we filmed like most of the time we filmed like 4 to 6 games at a time. Yeah. It's just like next one, next one, next one, next one. There was just bloodlust in the air. It's fucking
like
good.
One of the matches I recorded against, I think it was Ryan or something. It was like really early in the morning, and you were like, "We should do an NHL right now," and I was just like, "I don't want to do it." Like, there's no. You gotta get revved up and
it's
like watch other people first. It like really gets you going and stuff like that.
That for Gavin and I, that happens a lot with Play Pals, and that's he drinks a coffee, I drink a Red Bull, we bounce around, and then we start recording.
If you don't like slam your desk after someone else gets a goal, then you're not revved up.
Right.
Yeah.
Before. Right.
Yeah. You have to like get pissed.
But yeah, there was one episode, one game I filmed, and maybe you guys know which one it was, where I just did not want to do it. I was in a bad mood. I was having a bad day. I was exhausted.
Yep.
I had 1,000 things to do otherwise, but I knew I needed to do it. And I think it maybe
it
showed.
Just ruins it. Like,
it does.
You
it
know,
ruins
it's
it.
Like, hard to,
do
it's
you
hard.
Think it did?
That's how I felt.
Well,
my
we
match.
Talked about that. It did
I
seem
think
to
it
me, like, as the season
it's
went
hard
on,
to make,
we got more and more serious about it, too. Like, by the end, like, now in, like, in week six, like, everyone was dead silent when they were playing. Everyone was just focusing on the actual game. So,
I think
it's
in my
fun.
My week four match, I think, is against Lindsay. Because the way the tournament works is you play weeks 1, 2, and 3 against the other three people in your division, right? So, like, for you guys, if it was Jeff, you know, he'll play Michael, Jack, Matt. Then week 4 starts the same cycle again. So week 4 will play Michael, 5 Jack.
But you switch sides.
You go home and away. Home and away switches.
Yeah,
typical bracketing.
So the second time, because right now, because it's already been out that I face Lindsay on Tuesday. Like that video has already been
out. Right.
So in week 4, I'll go against Lindsay again, and Lindsay is 10 times better than she is in the one that just came out.
Yeah.
As are you. You
that
also
one,
suck
them.
In game
that
one.
That one. I am invested in. That is one that I got seriously like, motherfucker, like while playing.
My,
I remember that.
My favorite one, because I can't even, what video is it? Oh, it was the GTA we filmed. What is the name of that new game type we filmed with the like,
Sumo.
I haven't played it yet, but it's
okay.
Sumo.
Oh, no. Okay,
apparently
so
it's exactly like the
Glug Glug Slam. They took Glug Glug Slam and made, and they took another one of our game types.
How dare
fine.
They, Rockstar?
No, I'm saying go for it. They made
play your game the way you
they
think.
They made four different maps for us to use, though.
That's awesome.
So, and one of them literally is on Maze Bank.
Are you serious?
Yeah. It's all, that one's awesome. That one's only four players, yeah. I think.
All
the,
it's the, so
the,
small.
The other three are eight players. That one's four players. But in that video,
realize something.
Jeremy and I were on a team, and who was the, was it Ryan versus Ryan and Jack? Was that
no? I was on a team with Jack.
Yeah, it was me. Yeah,
was that what it was?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, was it me and Ryan?
No, it was. I don't even remember. You and Gavin.
Was
and
it?
Then, yeah, you and wait, wasn't it me no. and me and Jack?
No, you're full of shit.
You're talking about the one that six people played.
Six people played.
Yeah, because I was on a team with Ryan in that one.
You were on a team with Ryan. You were on a team with Gavin. I was on a team.
No,
with
No, I'm talking about the four player one.
Oh, the four player one. We filmed that one first. No one was on teams. Or did we do one with teams?
We
in
did.
That
we definitely did one with teams because it was me and you. That's when we had the huge fucking trucks and they had the shit.
Oh, I am monster truck.
Oh, yeah, yeah, anyway, the whole point I'm getting at
it was 2v2 until Maze Bank, and then it was
in this Let's Play. There was one part where Jeremy and I have monster trucks, and Jeremy kept screaming, "I am monster truck." And in one of the hockey videos, I don't know if it's the one you mentioned it before or not, Jeremy goes, "I am monster truck!" And for all the people not in that video,
with no
it was
context.
Like, what the fuck are you talking about? I was like, oh, he's monster
truck.
Dude,
I am
you
monster
better
truck.
Watch out.
I am monster truck.
He is monster
Listen,
truck.
Listen, that comes out on Monday.
That sounds like GTA. Shirt. Yeah, that is a shirt.
Man, did you guys talk about the GTA idea. We filmed yesterday?
Not really.
No, we have not.
We hit it up.
It's what? A great GTA.
That is another amazing GTA. It was another free play.
I don't know when it's coming out.
I have.
We're three ahead, three or four ahead right now.
I have the most boring footage for that thing. But cool. Maybe all I did was stand on
Way
the train.
To sell it.
All I did was sit on the train. You guys,
you had an awesome GTA.
Amazing.
It was boring.
All I did was do something.
I thought everybody had great footage, but this was
Except
a GTA. This was a get. I mean, I don't know where
listen, you had to have
is.
Someone be a cameraman.
This was a Grabby. It's true. This was a Gavin idea.
Grabby free.
We tweaked an old idea where he wanted us to get a car, a motorcycle, a boat, a jet ski, a plane, and a helicopter parked on a moving train. At the exact same time.
At the same time. That was the thing.
We might be, assuming we pulled that off, the single greatest gaming group of all time.
I mean, we were before that.
Yeah.
But it's like double.
Now we just might be.
If we
there's a slim chance.
We might have knocked ourselves down.
Saying that was the point of the Let's Play, there had to be someone on the train to make sure that the train stayed there. Because GTA, the way GTA works,
the train moves. And
Jeremy,
and both like
you
the
say
vehicles
that,
disappeared.
But
shit.
One of the things you did was maybe the most visually impressive in the video.
There were so many great moments.
There was a motorcycle moment with you.
Oh, yeah. That was
class.
But then you replicated very close.
I thought
close.
Mine was awesome until I saw yours.
Yeah, and then trying to get cars in there, because we spent a whole Let's Play just trying to get cars on the train.
Yeah.
And so it's like, okay, this is going to be a nightmare, and then stuff happened with that. Anyway, I don't want to
I was saying, like
it was
fun, because I love murdering everyone, like killing Jeff, and just smashing little Jay, and like offense, defense, just pummeling you into the ground. But it was fucking fun to like work together again.
By the way,
and we murdered each other anyway. I think Ryan killed people over and over again and pulled this like, "I'm so sorry, I'm sorry."
I went for a kill on Gavin.
But it was like us working together while we murdered each other. It was fun.
It's so fun to do those like free roam ones.
Yeah.
It's I don't know. We got to find a balance because I really like Rockstar has been knocking it out of the park,
dude. With the game types.
Yeah.
Like Sumo, it was awesome.
Like,
he's Monster Truck.
I haven't played
I am
so
Monster
know.
Truck.
That wouldn't happen without
every
Rockstar.
Every bullet counts. Fucking amazing.
I could play that. Amazing. I could play those games forever.
Every bullet counts. Offense, defense, greatest one.
Offense,
that's probably my favorite
awesome.
One.
I love
offense,
that game.
Defense is
the,
amazing.
What was the, what's the, what's it called? The Terminator one? Where you have the monster trucks and the bicycles? Or the 18-wheelers and the bicycles?
Hasta La Vista?
Hasta La Vista?
Right. Yeah.
Fucking amazing.
Yeah.
Like they have had some, and so we've been playing those because they're really, part of the fun of playing GTA is the creativity, but there's limitations to the game. When the developers make it, there's no limitations.
Yeah.
They make it perfectly.
Not at all.
So it works really well every time. So you know you're going to get a smooth game. You don't get 45 minutes in and realize your idea is not possible. So it's great to do those other game types. But it is fun to circle back and do the free Remy stuff. Like Yacht Party, you guys did when I was
like,
Yeah. Well, it's also, it's cool because, like, the audience is like, a lot of them like the offense defense and stuff like that, but they really like our ideas.
I hope they like, because we played offense defense like 48 times.
Yeah, you're going to get used
so
to this
go
one.
To.
We still have more in the can that haven't even come out yet. But, God, is that true?
That is true.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
The audience is like, you know, I like this and I like that. They all said it. Every single person ever was like, I love this Let's Play. I would never speak ill of it. I've never left a negative comment ever, and I never will.
Yeah.
But in addition to that, I like when you do the free play stuff. The best part about that is we also haven't done it in forever. So, like, I know for a fact in the video you're talking about, within 5 minutes, I'm flying a helicopter, and I'm like, dude, flying's fucking fun in GTA. Because it's been so long since we did like a game type where I'm flying. So it's like, we're super excited to play free play again. Sure. And like run around and just do whatever.
Yeah, I think the first
thing,
anytime we load GTA, the first thing I do is go to, like, I start in my apartment, I go downstairs, call a mechanic, call up Pegasus, get a plane, and then just go and fly until we start the Let's Play. Yeah. It's just so much fun to fly in that game.
Well, the reason this all came up, too, is because I was watching a compilation of Gavin getting mugged. So I made a compilation of all the moments Gavin got mugged. And so Gavin came over and he was watching it with me. And it was the episode where you guys, the whole point of it was literally just fucking around in planes. Okay. That was it. Like, I forget the name of the Let's Play, but you guys are just flying around the airport. Someone was in a Titan. Other people were. I don't even think the Bezras were around yet. And, like, just flying. And Gavin looked at it and he's like, that was, like, one of the most fun Let's Plays we've ever done. He's like, we just got to do something like that again. Just fucking around.
In that episode that we just played, I don't think this is a huge spoiler, and if it is, nobody's going to care. I kept trying to, in the one we just did, the plane car trailer, I kept trying to mug Gavin, and every time I went to mug him, it was like a mugger has already been called. Every single time. Like, for an hour and a half, I kept trying. I never got to successfully mug him.
We also haven't done that in forever, and it happens every single time. Jeremy called the first mugging. I saw it. I didn't say anything.
I didn't call the mugging. So
Jack called the mugging, and I saw it because, like, I'm constantly, especially when we're not in the middle of something, like looking at all the shit on the screen, and I see it come up like, Gavin's been mugged, whatever, and I'm like, fuck me, Gavin got mugged.
What is this?
That's the best dude when the muggers don't kill you.
That's the total money that's been stolen from him so far. Tabs on how much money's been taken from him.
So Jack called the mugging, and then either Jack said it or Gavin said it. Somebody mentioned it, and Gavin's like, God damn it, I wasn't even gonna mention it because I didn't want people to know. And I'm like, I already saw it, already gonna mug you. I'm gonna mug you. It's on. It was like Jack called the muggings, and everyone in the game was like, oh yeah.
It was like,
you're fucked. You're fucked. The whole game, just all
the
muggings.
The entire game, I'm like,
There was
one moment where I like drove over a mountain or something, you were in a helicopter, you're like, oh, I saw Jeremy drive over the mountain, looked pretty cool. Like 2 seconds later, I'm like, no, because I see a guy with a knife run over the mountain.
Yeah, I may have caught one on Jeremy.
Hands down, though, I will say, best mugging ever in history of our videos was the fucking gangland style initiation of Kerry. That's so good. When we beat him into the crew, and there was one guy who came at Kerry while he was running on the docks. He sees the mugger coming. Actually, maybe he didn't even see him. I think Kerry was on the docks and he jumped into the water and he's underwater swimming. The mugger ran to the docks, jumped into the water, and murdered him under the water. He stabbed him to death underwater. That was the best mugging in the history of GTA.
Kerry got it bad.
So fucking good.
That was funny.
We have fun.
We do. And we also have off-topic glasses.
Oh,
that's fun. Why don't I have any at my home yet?
You should take that one. Man. You can have that one.
Can I just take this?
Take it.
Sure.
Just put it in your pocket. Don't sit down on it.
It's a big pocket. Yeah.
That'd be a bad day.
GTA
be like glass ass. You can glass ass.
GTA is one of those games that's just consistently fun.
Show glass ass.
Is this the guy that like sits on the jar and then it explodes in his rectum?
And then there's all the blood
and glass. He's just pulling out all the chunks and the blood's pouring out of him.
Yeah.
It's a good way to finish off an episode. Just let that play with
Play us out.
It's a bad way to do anything else, though. God damn.
It's good.
He got it up there. It's just he underestimated the strength of his own anus. It was a mason jar. Yeah.
Oh, God.
Not something you want to explode inside your rectum.
That's one you bring up at like a Thanksgiving dinner.
Yeah.
And you're
check
this out.
Jeremy, you know what that cranberry sauce reminds me of?
Hey, quick question. You ever seen glass ass?
Hey, Uncle Pete, you ever seen a little picture I like called knife ass?
Yeah.
You guys know that one? Jesus.
They call me the sharded rectum.
Did you
have a weird thing with buttholes?
There was one.
I hate buttholes.
You're scared of them or something like that.
I hate buttholes. Yeah.
I hate buttholes. This is perfect for you then, because there was one, I can't remember what it was called, like the priest and the nun or something like that. But it was a man dressed up as a priest saying something along the lines of like there was a demon in him and the nun needed to extract the demon. And then she sucks the shit from his asshole.
Oh!
In a nun costume. Oh, and he's just going, oh, and she's just like,
you know that, like you know that, you know that old phrase, you know what rhymes with nun? Anal fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. She got it out of him, though.
She exercised the demons.
You know who found that video? Mike Croon found that
That
video.
Is not surprising.
Watched it with the Croonster.
Well, that pretty much does it for me.
Yeah.
It's
I
the old dusted
now.
Trail.
Are we good? All right. Well, thanks for joining us on episode 17. Dude, it's 201. It's right there, Jeff.
So should we call this Nun Fun? Is that what this was called?
Yeah.
But this was tons of fun.
I like that no one, if we named it that, no one would know.
Until 2 seconds
before it ended. That might be the best title, though. Yeah. Like, that'll keep them on the edge of their seat.
Clickbait. We gotta do it.
Nuns. Like the nun was when she was sucking the feces out of his asshole.
That's the thumbnail. Off-topic logo, and then the nun. Shit. Dude, Whoopi Goldberg as the nun.
Jack! Right? And like, bleh. Jack! See you next week.
Tyler is not a lucky man.
That's how you do it, baby.